Cooper Flagg, small forward, freshman, Newport, Maine.
Rolling out there for head coach Sean Shire in his third season at the helm. Coming up this spring, he's got an anniversary, the 2010 title team. 15 years, the anniversary of that win. He also won one as a coach back in 2015. The associate head coaches are Chris Carroll and Jay Lucas. The assistants are Manuel Dildy and Will Avery. And the director of player development is Justin Robinson. You also see some other familiar faces down around the bench areas. Theo John has been around the last few weeks with the program. Good to see him back around as the Blue Devils get set to roll it out there against Lincoln here this afternoon. The Lions are going to wear their road jerseys with blue jerseys and shorts, some orange lettering and numerals, some white trim in there as well. For the Blue Devils, the familiar home whites with Duke blue numerals and lettering and a Duke blue stripe down the side. Of course, the Blue Devils have played on their home floor already at Countdown to Craziness. Two different 10-minute games, but they're playing against each other in that one, so a different feel in the building here this afternoon. Should be a lively atmosphere as we'll watch the Blue Devils go left to right here in the opening half inside Cameron Indoor Stadium. Our perch is obviously in the crow's nest, high top Coach K court behind the team benches. And our officiating crew this afternoon, assigned by the ACC, is led by Bill Covington. He's assisted by Trey Stions and Adam Florey. It'll be Brown to jump it off opposite Garita. And we're just about set to get it started here on a Saturday afternoon. The first of two exhibition games this season, Arizona State awaits next Sunday night. Great to have you with us. Away we go as expected. The Blue Devils control the opening tap. And the men wearing the headband will bring them across. That's Caleb Foster. Shovels one off to the left and James right back up top for Caleb. Swings it low with the basketball. Now to the top of the key and Knipple swings it over on the right to James. Quickly inside for Flag. A step through, pulls up from 4 feet out, rattles it home, and it's a 2-0 start.
Right off the bat, the National Preseason Freshman of the Year drains his first shot to get it started.
And immediately they pick it up full court, man-to-man defensively for John Shire. In backcourt, Foster all over Hudson. Hudson last year, their leading assist man, had 147 with 65 turnovers. Baseline drive, wild shot. Tip controlled by Brown. Didn't even catch a piece of the rim. Knipple out of there with it now, and here comes James. Along the right sideline, bringing it left to right. Brown alone at the top of the key. To the left, Foster, a good look from three, and it's 5-0, not even a minute in.
He'll be running this show, but we know from last year, especially Michigan State, that Caleb Foster can drain an outside shot.
As Hudson brings it across. Shovels one off to the right into the arms of Young. They play catch up top. Garita gets a touch. Swing it over to the left. Now Hudson. And now back up top. Young trying to drive Cooper Flagg on the right baseline. Got inside. Dangerous pass. Threw it away. Came to the top of the key. And Hudson floats with the right hand. Whistle. I think we're going to get a foul on the way in. That'll be on Caleb. And that's the first on either team with 18:42 to play here in the opening half. The Blue Devils looking crisp early on both ends of the floor.
They certainly are. I know one thing you talked to John Shire about was playing defense without fouling, because this is a team that got to the line a lot last year. They're adept at that aspect of the game. We'll see how that plays out throughout the afternoon.
Cleveland inbound in front of the Blue Devil bench, having a really hard time, finally able to bounce it in into the arms of Sorber. Tries to clear some space, got rid of it for Hudson. To the right it goes. A three is blocked by Flag. Out of the hands of Young. And Cooper said no along the right sideline. It'll stay with Lincoln as it went out of bounds along the baseline.
Putting that 6'9" length to good work over in the corner.
Goodness. 12 to shoot as they inbound. Bounce it into the right corner for Garita. Trying to drive Flag. Got inside, bodied him up, put it up, and got it to go. Strong finish for Garita. First points of the afternoon for the Lions. Foster quickly across midcourt, leading by three. To the baseline, whistle, offensive foul. An illegal screen is going to be called on Malik Brown. That'll be his first and the second on the Blue Devils. And with 18:23 to go here in our first half, Lincoln has it back. Trying to get some space up top, it's Garita. A handoff for Hudson. Gets a screen, works his way to the right. Brown recovers onto him. Knipple now has the defensive assignment at the top of the key. Dogging Young, 10 to shoot, into the paint. Tries to spin him, nothing doing. Back cut, though, and a wild layup is no good. Out of the arms of Bakir Cleveland, but a foul is called, and he'll shoot two. And that is already three quick fouls on the Blue Devils, and this is something Lincoln likes to do. They like to get to the free throw line. They make about 17 per game a year ago. About a quarter of their points came at the charity stripe, and they were a good free throw shooting team, just shy of 72%. Cleveland made more than 80% of his attempts at the charity stripe.
Got loose on a nice backdoor cut, though, and the foul came by the Blue Devils trying to make up on defense from behind.
Able to hit the first free throw. Averaged just north of 13 points a year ago. Underwater in terms of the assist to turnover ratio. 49 to 52, assists versus turnovers. Started most of their games, and the second free throw cuts the deficit to one. So 5-4, 18:01 to play, just underway here in the first half. Lincoln extending some full court pressure with Young. And now Kayla Foster will have it on the right side of the floor, defended by Hudson. Brings it across midcourt with 2 seconds to spare. Now Flagg has it between the rings. Off of the screen, works his way to left, into the corner. James thought about a three and said he'll drive. An airborne pass up top to Foster. A touch pass for Knippel on the right. Too strong on a three. They fight for the rebound. Foster has it. Room to shoot. He'll leave it for James. Back to Foster. Knocked out of bounds, but it actually went off the ref and stayed in bounds. A fortuitous bounce for Young. He drives. Blocked by Foster, by Flagg, I should say. My goodness. And then a foul on the rebounding action. Cooper high above the rim to swat that away. And then the Blue Devils called for a foul on the rebounding action. That was Knippel. And it'll be a baseline out of bounds opportunity for Lincoln. I mean, he was 3 feet above the rim.
Oh, my goodness. His elbow was about even with the top of the rim as he swatted that ball away.
They are going to say it was on the shot attempt. Excuse me. So 2 free throws coming for Garrido. And the first one ties the game at 5, and this is kind of what they want to do, John. I mean, they like to get to the free throw line, and already you look up, and the Blue Devils have 4 fouls in the first 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, they had, I think, 3 different guys who were over 100 in free throw attempts across their 31 games last year, so they're adept at this.
Chance to put them in front for the first time on the second attempt, rimmed out, tied at 5, 17:30 to play in our first half. Foster across midcourt. Shovels one off to the left. There's Cooper Flagg, and now Caleb has it again. Around to the right, Knippel inside. Cooper's got it. Tried to dump it off to Brown, and he throws it down with 2 hands. And it's 7-5. Not even 3 minutes in. Along the left baseline, Sorber had to get rid of it. Hudson now trying to get it inside, swatted away by Caleb Foster. And there's that length we talked about. Caleb jokes that he's the shortest guy on the roster at 6'5", but even he can get up and swat one away.
Yeah, he's still got pretty good size for a point guard at 6'5".
It'll be Cleveland inbound left sideline. Taking his time, lobs it up top, and dangerous pass. Sorber couldn't catch it, knocked loose by Brown. Here's Flagg the other way, off the window. That should count on a goaltend, I believe. We'll see where the foul is, though. Count the basket, and he'll have a chance for three.
Cooper ended up in the baseline seating area that time, slow to get up, but looks like he's okay.
Put it off the right window. The foul was committed on the way in by Young, and the block was after it hit the backboard, and now Cooper is shaking his right hand loose before he attempts the first free throw of the game for John Shire's group. Caleb over for a word of encouragement to the young freshman. Now we'll see the free throw. The Blue Devils have hit 4 of their first 5 from the field, and the free throw rattled out. So it's still a 4-point cushion, 9-5. Duke scored the first 5, the next 5 for Lincoln, and now the Blue Devils have scored the last 4. Hudson has it up top. 16:50 to go in our first half. He'll drive to the right baseline, pull up from 15, and hit. Reggie Hudson with his first field goal, and it makes it 9-7. Caleb across midcourt, baseline drop. Got right by Young, missed the layup though, and the rebound out of there. Lincoln has it with Hudson. Shovels one ahead, deep pass deflected by Knippel out of bounds along the left baseline. Lincoln will keep it. But the Blue Devils doing a nice job to chase back in transition to prevent the easy opportunity inside. And it'll be the Lions to inbound in the form of Freddie Young. All 5 starters are seniors for them. It's just a very experienced group for their head coach, as we see Tyrese Proctor first off the bench for the Blue Devils today. The junior guard, 6'6", 183, out of Sydney, Australia. Averaged 10.5 a year ago. As James will get a breather, they go inside for Sorber, and we get a foul on the Blue Devils. I think they're going to get Cooper reaching in. And that'll be Cooper Flagg's first foul. Haven't seen the number exactly yet. No, they're going to call it on Brown, and that's his second. So it wasn't Cooper on ball defending, it was off the ball.
Brown kind of curious body language there, like, what did I do?
Now our lead official, Bill Covington, is over checking who the foul is on, and they put it on Cooper Flag.
Yeah, Brown was really not involved too much in the pass.
And now they're going to bring Cooper Flag over the bench because I think he's bleeding on that right hand that he was shaking out earlier. Jose Fonseca, the trainer for the Blue Devils, is going to tend to the talented freshman.
Well, when he landed in the baseline seating area, he hit one of the cameramen down there underneath the basket and could have easily got a little cut there on that drive.
Yeah, of course, a part of this top recruiting class in the country, that's become old hat for John Shire, probably something you shouldn't take for granted how well he's done in the recruiting department. Five top 20 players in the 247 sports rankings, a member of this class. And, of course, you have all those transfers that are coming in that are so good. Talking about Gillis, we already see Brown out there. We've seen James, and I'm sure we'll see Sheffield at some point this afternoon.
I'm going to see Evans for sure from that recruiting class as well.
Mm-hmm. As it'll be Young to get it in, having a hard time, lobs it into the corner. Garita goes high to catch it. Plenty of time, 20 on the shot clock. Hudson. Working with the left-hand dribble. The Blue Devils lead it by a bucket, 9-7, 3.5 minutes in. Hudson looking to lob one inside. Got it for Sorber along the right baseline. Cross-court pass. Dangerous. Nearly threw it away. Able to save it as Cleveland. 7 to shoot. Thinking about a 3. A bounce pass to the baseline. 5 to shoot. Going to work inside Garita. He lost it, but it came right to Sorber, who punches it down to tie the game.
Sorber with a strong finish. Their top rebounder from last year ties it up at 9.
Meanwhile, on the right, it's Knippel for 3. Got it. And you got to give Cooper Flag a lot of credit. A tremendous ball fake that saw the defender fly by, and that left Knippel wide open. For the Blue Devils, second deep ball, it's 12-9. Duke in front, just over 4 minutes in. Step back at the other end for Hudson from the top of the key. No, and Proctor has the rebound. Blue Devils really pushing the pace in transition. Tyrese for the trailer. Knippel thought about another one and said he'll drive. Leave it to Brown for a two-hand flush.
A couple of times now, Brown has been ready and willing to finish these offensive possessions off with two-handers, and that puts Duke up 5.
So 5 quick points for the Blue Devils after Lincoln had tied the game. 14-9, 15-20 to go in our first half. A bounce pass to the baseline. There's Sorbor for Lincoln. Trying to back down Knippel. Looking cross court. Deflected on the way through, but it came to Hudson, who floats from 6 feet out and scores. So he's got 4, and it's 14-11, just about 5 minutes in.
They're hitting
Flag going to lead the break this time.
They're hitting 50% here early in the going from the field.
And Flag just committed his second foul on an illegal screen. It's going to chase us to a timeout. 15:02 to play here in our opening half. Just underway, it's the Blue Devils 14 and the Lions 11.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks to help grow businesses, communities, families. A legacy of capability and technology that has made Ford F-Series America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of Built Ford Tough. Based on 1977 to 2023 calendar year total sales.
He'll fire, and it's good!
This is Duke head men's basketball coach John Shire. When it comes to keeping our team healthy, we turn to the team at Duke Sports Medicine. We offer full-service sports medicine care at locations throughout the Triangle, where you can see the same experts used by Duke Athletics. Make an appointment or learn more at dukehealth.org/sportsmedicine. Go Duke!
The crowd loves that. To play in the first half, the Blue Devils 14, the Lions 11. David Schumate alongside John Roth for our first exhibition game of the season. John Rose is our producer and engineer. Back inside our network studios is Kyle Schatzberger. Don't forget that no one gets you closer to the game than SiriusXM ACC Radio. Tune in for news, talk, and analysis from the offseason through the regular season and into the postseason. We've got your team covered anywhere you go. Get a free trial at SiriusXM/ACC Radio 2024. Well, we thought we might see a lot of different guys play today, John. Might be out of necessity. Cooper Flagg just picked up his second. 6 fouls already for the Blue Devils, not even 5 minutes in.
Yeah, most of the starters already have at least one foul here as this contest has gotten underway. So just seen the bench just kind of spring into action with Tyrese Proctor coming off a couple of moments ago, and we're going to possibly see a couple of more now as we get back into action here. But certainly something you got to manage, and let's have a lesson on it early here in the first game. We can't foul. So that's kind of the idea of playing defense. You got to be tough, but not foul. And we'll be delivered home here more pointedly when you have some foul trouble in the first 5 minutes.
Well, two guys are going to check in out of the timeout. One will be the Big Ten Sixth Man of the Year from a year ago, Mason Gillis, who played for a national title for Purdue a year ago. The other, kind of the opposite end of the spectrum from an experience standpoint, just started playing basketball about 5 years ago. Talking about number nine, Kamon Maluwash, the freshman center, 7'2", 250, out of Rumbek, South Sudan. We know about the wingspan, 7'5", the 9'8" standing reach. And when you look at the roster for Lincoln, and this may be the case for a lot of teams the Blue Devils play this year, John, there's no answer for that.
There's no answer for that. Their tallest guy, they've got a couple of 6'9" guys, but the reach just makes such a big difference for Maluwash. And I'm just really excited to see how he gets started and comes along here early in his college basketball journey. Obviously coming off of playing for his country in the Olympics over the summer, so the talent is certainly there in the background. But let's just see how well he develops in really an intense basketball laboratory to begin his college career.
So Cooper flagged to the bench with 15:02 to go in the first half with those two fouls after the illegal screen a moment ago. And here's Hudson on a baseline drive, whips one to the corner. Young thought about a three, couldn't fire. Inside, deflected, stolen. Maluwash has it. And now here's Tyrese trying to add to a three-point lead in transition. Steps to the right, launches, can't hit. Weak side rebound, Knipple able to claim it. A chance to reset up top to the corner. It goes for Gillis on the left, can't hit the three. Knipple nearly had another offensive rebound. It's out of bounds. Last touch by Lincoln. And you get a little taste of what everyone saw over the summer in practice with Con Knipple and why everyone was so excited about him, just very active around the hoop.
He is a gamer. He just keeps going at 100% the whole time.
Foster to cue the inbound along the right baseline, looking inside. Nothing there. Lobs it near midcourt. Dangerous pass. Tyrese able to claim it. Whips it to the left for a Knipple three. That's good. Con Knipple with his second consecutive three, and with all the work he did on the offensive glass, very much deserved there. It builds the lead to 6, 17-11.
One of those top 20 high school players, number one in the state of Wisconsin from last year's high school class, and delivers on the three.
Kind of close your eyes throwing at the dartboard with these freshmen. You got a player of the year either nationally or within their state. As Hudson sends one off to the right. Garita right back to Hudson. 10 to shoot. 6 minutes gone. 17-11 our score. He fades away from 17 and hits over Gillis. So Hudson off to a good start. He's got 6 and it's 17-13. Maluwash leaves it up top for Knipple. He'll take a three. No, too strong. And the rebound for Lincoln. There's a shoe out near midcourt. Kind of in the area. Everybody's running over to claim it is Cleveland. For Lincoln, trying to put it on as he walks up the court. Meanwhile, Hudson behind the back got inside from 17. Too strong this time on the jumper, and the rebound for Tyrese Proctor. Blue Devils trying to add to a four-point lead. 17-13, the advantage, 13:25 to go in the half. Maluwash for Knipple. Baseline drive, whistle, and a hold is going to be called on the Lions. And I think Cleveland raised his hand to say, I committed the foul because I'm trying to get my shoe back on.
He was trying to guard the Duke player with one hand open and one hand with a shoe in it, and might have got Con on the hip with his shoe as he was going around him in his hand.
It'll be Caleb Foster to inbound. Oh, yeah, Gillis underneath, didn't see him. Up top, Tyrese has it now. Drives the left baseline, got inside, hangs, puts it off the window, no, but he's fouled and will shoot two.
That's really twice out-of-bounds underplays the last two possessions where Gillis has come off a screen and found himself wide open under the basket, but Caleb kind of vision blocked by the man guarding the inbound.
The foul on Lincoln will be on Elijah Nix, a sophomore in the Newark, New Jersey. As Proctor's first free throw was no good. Lincoln is in Pennsylvania, about an hour southwest of Philadelphia. But you wouldn't know it looking at this roster. You'd think it's in Jersey. All these different guys from New Jersey as the Blue Devils see Sion James come back into the game. Of course, the transfer from Tulane.
I got a couple from New York, the Bronx, and Harlem, home area of Julius Hodge, their head coach. But, yeah, it just reads New Jersey down the line.
Proctor one out of two at the line as he makes the second. 18-13, the lead is 5 as we approach 13 minutes to play in the half. Jackson up off the bench, working at the top of the key. for Lincoln. Trying to set a screen. Sorber, instead, he has it at the top of the key. Whips one inside. They had a man open and able to lay it in off the right. Is Jhené Coates-Sinews. His first field goal cuts it to 3, 18-15. Proctor into the paint, rises up with the right hand and scores. What a tough finish for Tyrese Proctor, and it builds a lead back to 5.
But a very aggressive offensive move, just really taking it coast to coast and getting the finish.
By the way, Darren Harris is out on the floor for the first time for the Blue Devils. He's out there with Gillis, Proctor, Malawach, and James defending the basket to our left. A 5-point cushion for John Shire's group, 7.5 minutes in. Sorber, a handoff up top. Cleveland trying to get inside. Bobbled it, collected it. Whistle, he traveled, trying to collect it. And a turnover for Lincoln. That is their third, and Lincoln's going to talk it over. This will extend to a full. We'll take it as well. 12:27 to play here in the first half. It's the Blue Devils 20 and the Lions 15.
With all these new winners at the North Carolina Education Lottery Winners Club, we need to decide who's in charge.
We need a top prize winner.
We need someone who's good with words, like us crossword winners.
If elected leader, I will extend the hours during which all winners can use the diamond-encrusted hot tub.
Yes. New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets are packed with $370 million in total prizes. The Winners Club awaits. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning range from 1 in 3.04 to 4.31. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
For the latest in news, notes, and special content, head to goduke.com. This is the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield.
It's not just football season. It's tailgate season. And that includes every kind of football, whether it's got goalkeepers or goalposts.
The kick is good!
Because it doesn't matter where or how you tailgate. When you've got crispy chicken and fluffy buttermilk biscuits from Bojangles, your tailgate is better than great. It's legendary. Head to Bojangles and order your tailgate box with boldly seasoned chicken, fixins, biscuits, and legendary iced tea today. It's Bo time.
This is Coke Zero Sugar. Could I be the best Coke ever? Try and taste with your ears. Hear those bubbles? Imagine them tingling on your tongue. Fizzy deliciousness. Listen to that cascading liquid. A mouth-watering waterfall. Irresistibly tasty. Zero sugar. Crisp, refreshing, and ice cold. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide.
.27 to play in our first half. It's Blue Devils 20 and the Lions 15. Don't forget the Sharp Business System sets the same standard of excellence in office equipment as the Blue Devils do in basketball. Count on Sharp for state-of-the-art office equipment. Sharp, changing the way companies do business. As the Blue Devils have this 5-point lead, they're shooting the basketball really well, 62%, having hit 8 of their first 13 shots from the field, 3 out of 7 from 3. They lead the rebounding battle 7-5. They give Lincoln some credit as well. They're hitting their shots 6 out of 11, better than 50%, 3 of 4 at the line. They got a couple of assists. And, John, when you got ready for this game, as we were kind of looking over stuff, hey, we're talking with Coach about this in the pregame show if you guys weren't with us. A lot of times when you're playing, you know, over the years, it's been the Division II champ or the CIAA champion. It's a whole new roster because the team that won that, a lot of times those guys are graduating or moving on. Not the case with this group. All the returners back, and I think we're seeing that a very experienced team in Lincoln led by a head coach that's certainly familiar with the ACC and knows what it's like to play in Cameron.
True. Julius Hodge is their head coach, former NC State player. The one thing that is different for them is that coming into this game to prepare, they really didn't know what kind of style Julius Hodge would try to impose on all those veterans. So you got all the personnel back, all the experience, but in a completely new system. So I'm sure from their standpoint, they're also trying to figure out how they want to be running this team this year. And so this is a good learning ground for them as well.
Out of the timeout, it's Gillis, James, Proctor, Malawach, and Harris out there. Proctor has it on the left, going to jump up from three. Missed it short. The rebound fought for inside, out of bounds. Last touch by Lincoln as Malawach able to knock it off of Coates and Use. And it'll stay with the Blue Devils. Active defensively early on, a couple of steals. We've talked about the offensive rebounds already with 3. As a team, as James will cue the inbound, having a hard time, and a 5-second call. And a 4th turnover here in the first 8 minutes or so.
And usually that's not the fault of the guy throwing the ball inbounds. There was nobody really breaking free. Lincoln had done a nice job of defending the 4 Blue Devils that were trying to cut off of each other to receive the pass.
Hudson will bring it across. Trying to feed the post. Coates in use, not open because Gillis is all over him. Off of the screen, Hudson defended by Gillis now, trying to drive to the right baseline. Hangs, blocked by Malawach, and he claims the loose basketball. Here comes James across midcourt, left to right. Weaving into the paint, left it for Malawach. On the drive, put it off the window, counted it a foul. Big fella doing it at both ends, and the lead grows to 7.
The defensive play, running the floor, the offensive finish, and now a chance to add one.
Wait, are they going to say this foul was on the floor? So no basket for Malawach. John Shire over asking, saying he was shooting.
I guess they're going to say that he committed the foul on the jump stop before he actually shot. Although, to me, that's all in one motion.
It's also the preseason. Can we get some and-one stuff going on? Goodness. Yeah. James to inbound. Locks it for Proctor. So the lead is 5. Give my man an and-one opportunity. On the right, James going to try from outside. Can't hit the 3. And the rebound into the hands of Sorber for Lincoln. On the right, it's Jackson. Into the paint he goes. Leaves it back up top. Sorber going to try 3. Won't go. The rebound fought for. Lincoln has it. And a foul on the Blue Devils. And this will be a one-on-one opportunity on the 7th team foul as Sion James picks up number 2. And we'll see Malik Brown come back into the game. The transfers from Syracuse, junior forward 6'9", 222 out of Culpeper, Virginia. Knipple in there. So is Foster, Proctor, and Gillis, the other two on the floor.
First 8.5 minutes, Coach John Shire has used 9 players so far off of his roster.
As expected. We'll see Coates in use at the line. The senior out of Newark averaged just shy of 8 points a game a year ago. 66% at the line, and he hits the front end of the 1-1. As we told you at the top, they like to get to the free throw line. They've already taken 5, made 4 of them. And this will be attempt number 6. And he rattles it home. They're 5 out of 6. And just like that, they're back within 3, 20-17, with 11.5 minutes to go until the break. Foster with a right-hand dribble. Underhand scoop. Proctor now up top. It comes for Gillis. Gets the screen back to the right. Tyrese. Into the corner for Caleb Foster. Back up top. Proctor. He wants to drive. Into the paint. Righty scoop. Got it. Off the window and down. Tyrese Proctor has 5. And the lead is 5, 22-17. Bringing it up this time for Lincoln is Chase Jackson, defended by Caleb Foster. 9 minutes gone. Blue Devils with a 5-point lead in their first exhibition game of the season. Hudson now lobs it into the post, facing up his coach Sinus, and he lays it in on the right. So it's 22-19. His coach Sinus now has 6. On the right, Knipple wants to drive into the paint, spins to the middle, working with a left-hand dribble, got some space, but then had it stripped on the way up cleanly by Toa. And here comes Lincoln the other way, down by 3. Off of a screen sent by Sorber. It's Hudson. Now he sends it back to the right. Hudson has it again in front of the bench. Inside Sorber, knocked loose by Foster. May have dinged up his left hand, and he might have to come out of the game. Bent over in pain in front of the Blue Devil bench as Cooper Flagg returns. And Caleb will immediately walk to the end of the bench to visit with Jose Fonseca. You hope that he's all right. Meanwhile, Cooper had been out since the 15:02 mark with those 2 fouls. As they lob it in for Sorber, deflected, stolen. Gillis got a piece. And now a run out for Brown to throw it down.
Third dunk of the game so far for Brown. Puts the Blue Devils back up by 5.
24-19 as we approach the midway point of the opening half. Jackson going to bring it up, defended by Tyrese Proctor. Gets the screen for Sorber, gets some space, sends it to the right. Hudson going to take a 3, a rainbow that wouldn't go, and it's out of bounds. A foul coming, I believe, on Lincoln. We'll see. Well, I thought the official raised his arm to say foul. Or did he just say out of bounds? I think he's going to say possession for the Lions there. I thought I saw a raised fist. Did you see the same thing?
I thought it was a foul. I didn't think it was a foul play, but I thought it was a called foul.
So they'll reset the shot clock to 20, and Lincoln will be back in possession along the left baseline with 9:56 to go in the first half. Jackson waiting. Dangerous lob pass. A lollipop that comes into the arms of Toa. Drives inside on the right side of the paint. Slid the pivot foot and turned it over. Their 5th.
under pressure from Con Knipple on the drive that time, and Blue Devils get it back, try to add to the lead.
Choppy here, I'd say, midway through the first half with the Blue Devils leading by five. Proctor for flag at the top of the key. Cooper, bounce pass for Knipple, some holding going on, and there goes the whistle. This will be on Hudson, and that's his first, and that is a fifth team foul on Lincoln. Proctor comes over for some instructions from the head coach of the Blue Devils, John Shire. He's out there with Knipple, Brown, Flagg, and Gillis.
Somebody has to inbound.
I got time to figure it out. It'll be Mason who comes over. Along the right baseline, left side of the hoop. As we see things behind the team benches, now Brown has it into the corner for Tyrese Proctor. Low with the basketball, into the paint. He's been aggressive earlier, and he's rewarded with a foul here. He's reaching in his young, and that's his second. Sixth team foul. And we're going to shoot some free throws here in the first half. The Blue Devils have been whistled for seven. Lincoln now six, and we've still got 9:39 to play until the break. And we've already seen nine combined attempts at the charity stripe. Proctor waiting, lobs it in for Brown. Into the left corner, Tyrese for Cooper Flagg. Back up top, Knipple has it, looking to drive. Got to the right side of the paint, back up top for a Cooper Flagg three, and he hits it. Cooper now with seven, and the lead as big as it's been all day at 8, 27-19.
Perfect three for three from the floor so far with three assists.
9:19 to play as they go inside, and a scoop with the left hand is good out of the hands of Reggie Hudson. He's got 8, 27-21. Proctor quickly across midcourt. Nearly lost it up top. Underhand scoop for Flagg to the left. Knipple's open. And he hits a three. Con Knipple with his third three-pointer. And the Blue Devils lead by 9, 30-21.
I think fifth three for the Blue Devils so far.
Bounce pass to the left. Toa has it for Lincoln. Whistle inside. Battling. And a foul is going to be called on Malik Brown. And that's number two on him. And back to the free throw line will go Lincoln. So you've got Flagg with two, Brown with two, and now James with two as well. As Maluach will come in relief of Malik Brown, who has a C with 8:53 to play here in the first half. You want to learn things in the preseason, going to learn how to navigate some foul difficulty here today. For Lincoln, Cleveland, and Young, each with two. And now here's Sober at the line, shooting 1-1, below 60% at the line. A year ago. And the front end, too strong. And the rebound for Knipple. A chance to add to a 9-point lead with 8:50 to play in the half. Cooper Flagg has it off of a screen set by Maluach. Drifts to the right, a crossover, a pull up, fouled, counted, and a chance for three. Knocked to the deck, and he hit it anyway.
Cooper Flagg from the wing right in front of the Lincoln bench, stepped inside the three-point arc and drained that shot under heavy pressure.
Now 9 points, as John told you earlier, still perfect from the field. Four out of four with a three mixed in. Four assists as well. That leads the team. And the free throw is good. And for the first time today, a double-digit lead, 33-21. His flag is the first into double figures for either side. As we approach 8.5 minutes to play until the break. Off of a screen, it's Hudson on the right. Drives Tyrese Proctor. Backs out, crosses over, tries to drive again. Maluach protecting the rim, so had to get rid of it up top. Young has it now. 10 to shoot, a crossover at the free throw line. Looking inside, nothing there. To the left it goes, and Cleveland. Five on the timer. Cleveland over flag. Hits a three from the top of the key. But here, Cleveland, he's got five. And it's 33-24.
One of their double-figure scorers is four that returned for this year's team from last year, and showing why there.
Duke has made each of their last five shots in the field. Proctor trying to add to it, cannot, but he's fouled and will shoot two. And that'll be on Young, and that's number three. With 7:59 to go, so free throws coming out of the timeout. We take a break. Midway point of the opening half, it's the Blue Devils 33 and the Lions 24.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Duke Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
I feel happy. Valero Pay Plus app.
I feel happy. It makes savings a snap.
Use it and start saving automatically.
You just save some money. Now do shine.
I feel happy. I'm in and out real fast.
I feel happy. Now pit stops are a blast.
I love today and get in on the fun. Valero Pay Plus app. You save with happy gun.
Let me grab my car keys and we'll roll.
We still going to that new bar downtown?
Yeah, supposed to be fun. Lexi, give me driving directions from home to downtown bar district.
Autocorrect. Suggest Uber. Pick up. Home. Drop off downtown bar district.
No, I'm driving.
Suggest the Metro bus. Departing in 12 minutes.
Point taken, Lexi. We'll grab a ride.
If you drink, don't drive. Decide to ride. Brought to you in partnership by Anheuser-Busch, Mothers Against Drunk Driving, and Uber.
Devils have knocked down five consecutive field goals, have taken a nine-point lead on Lincoln University in this exhibition matchup, and it's the highly touted Cooper Flagg making his mark on this contest through the first half.
A chance to add to a nine-point lead with 8:50 to play in the half. Cooper Flagg has it off of a screen set by Malawach. Drifts to the right, a crossover, a pull-up, fouled, counted, and a chance for three. Knocked to the deck, and he hit it anyway.
Free throw was good for Flagg. He's got 10 points, the only one in double figures. Perfect 4 of 4 from the floor, 33-24. 8 minutes to play in the first half. I'm Kyle Schatzberger. Now back inside Cameron. Here's John Roth.
And speaking of Flagg scoring so far, let's check out the rest of our in-game stats presented by Steel. Pro-level performance at work and at home. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. Flagg, the only double-figure score for either side here. Con Knippel for Duke, though, also is the next leading scorer with 9 points on 3 out of 5 shooting, 6 points for Brown on 3 dunks, and 5 for Therese Proctor. Blue Devil shooting 65%. They've got 9 assists on their 13 buckets so far. On the other side of the ledger, Hudson with 8 points on 4 out of 9 shooting. They're shooting 53% with 3 assists on their 9 baskets, and overall, the Blue Devils out rebounding their opposition by a 10-8 margin so far. Turnovers dead even at 5 apiece. 33-24 with 7:59 to go in this first half. As we get back to action, David, it'll be Therese Proctor at the free throw line.
And Therese looking to add to a really good start. 5 points already. Has been to the free throw line a couple times already. Now he's 2 out of 3 at the charity stripe as he hits the first. He's got 6. The two leading scorers are freshmen. Cooper Flagg has 10. Con Knippel has 9. And now Proctor and Brown each with 6. Therese trying to add a 7th, and he got the roll. As we see Caleb Foster come back in, and Therese will get a breather. 35-24 with 7:59 to play in the half. The Blue Devils have led by as many as 12. They have never trailed in this one. Although Lincoln was there toe-to-toe for about the first 9-10 minutes of the game, with the Blue Devils starting to get some separation now as Hudson comes off of a screen, drives, tries the lob, and a spectacular finish by Garita. Couldn't dunk it, but able to tip it home high above the rim. They cut it to 9. Flagg to the left. There's Caleb Foster for 3, a rainbow that wouldn't go. Malawach the offensive rebound. A chance to reset with a fresh shot clock. Cooper Flagg on the drive. He's bodied up and fouled on the way in by Jameer Brewer, a freshman on this team for Lincoln. That is team foul number 9. So this will be a 1-1 opportunity for Cooper Flagg. Gives us a chance to tell you that Food Line is the proud sponsor of the Score to Give More program. For every free throw made by the Blue Devils this year, Food Line will make a donation to help our neighbors in need. Last year alone, Food Line donated 30,000 meals to support our local community. And the first attempt for Cooper is on the way, and he hits the front end of the 1-1. So he's got 11 now. Takes the lead back to 10, a chance to build it back to 11 with 7:33 to go until the break. We've seen the defense, the spectacular block at the other end before a foul was called. We've seen the offense probably could have had a little bit more production if not for the early fouls. But a couple of and-one opportunities. We saw the 3 at the top of the key. And John, it feels like as he hits the second free throw, they're just scratching the surface of what he's capable of.
Absolutely, and we hope to see some of those other capabilities as this season progresses. At only game one right here, but a lot to work with there.
An 11-point lead, 37-26, with 7:20 to play in the half. Cleveland works his way off of a screen to the left, got to the baseline, drilled off his own leg out of bounds. They say last touch by Cooper Flagg. I thought that might have hit the knee of Cleveland. But with 10 to shoot, he'll stay on this end of the floor.
I think Cooper might have just mentioned that.
Perhaps a little more vociferously when you get into the regular season, but here in the preseason, you're making friends with the officials.
Right. Right.
As Lincoln lobs it in for Sorber, and now a handoff. Nix has it. A bounce pass to Sorber along the left baseline. Three to shoot. Does he know it? Fades away from 15. Hits the bracket and then goes down. A friendly roll, and he had something to say to the Duke bench as he's got four. 37 to 28. Little Bulls by nine. Cooper Flagg with it now. Whips it to the right, Knippel. He'll take a three, and there's the answer. How much you want to talk to the Blue Devil bench with all the talent over there? It's 40 to 28.
So another three for Knippel and another assist for Flagg. The two freshmen have helped Duke go up by 12.
Gunshire's got a feisty bunch this year. Don't think they didn't notice somebody talking a little bit. As Cleveland sends it up top for Hudson. A lot of talk in the offseason about how competitive the workouts have been, the scrimmages. They're excited to bring it to the floor now, albeit an exhibition action, but getting to play some opposition as Hudson goes with a 15-footer that's no good off the left, and Malawach has the rebound. You got the sense they were just chomping at the bit to get out here. Flagg trying to add to a tremendous start. Underhand scoop leaves it for Foster. Steps back, sends it to the corner, and Gillis playing catch on the left side of the floor. Foster has it again. Drives inside, puts it off the window. Blocking foul. Count it. And a chance for three. And Sorber picks up number two.
Caleb Foster showing a lot of grit, driving to the basket and taking that contact and still finishing a guy in front of him and a guy behind him, kind of slicing his way in there. And certainly he's one of the most eager Blue Devils to get this season going after missing the end of last year with that injury that kept him out of the postseason completely, and worked really hard to get back into top playing performance. And he's certainly one of the guys who's been very anxious to get going here.
Yeah, February 24th, that game against Wake Forest was the last time we saw him last year. Trying to complete the three-point play. Can't hit the free throw. Nearly a chance for an offensive rebound, but Garita has it for Lincoln. Meanwhile, the Blue Devils have hit seven of their last eight from the field. They're shooting better than 65% from the field, including 6 of 13 from outside. Garita leaves it for Hudson. Gillis defending him. Already down to 10 to shoot as he backs out near midcourt, tries to penetrate again, steps to the right, just flings one up, can't hit from 15, and Gillis the rebound. An outlet pass for Caleb Foster, streaming across midcourt left to right, whips it to the corner for Knippel. His three is good. Con Knippel is feeling it. He's 5 of 7 from outside, and Lincoln wants a timeout. We'll break for 30. All of a sudden, the lead is 17, 45 to 28.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Duke Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
Five and a half minutes to go until the break. David Schumann alongside John Roth. John Rose, our producer and engineer, back inside our network studios, is Kyle Schassberger. It has been an explosion on the offensive end of the floor that has seen the Blue Devils go up by 17, 45 to 28. The latest push, 8-0 over the last 82 seconds. And John has been bombs away from outside, particularly for Con Knippel.
It certainly has been. Duke's hit 7 threes already, and he's knocked down 5 of them. I mean, think about the pedigree. His mom's the all-time scoring leader at Wisconsin Green Bay. His dad's in the Hall of Fame at Wisconsin Lutheran. So certainly basketball a part of his life, and he has come to play here for the Blue Devils, knocking down the perimeter shots here in this first half of his first game.
And Ho-Om, 16 makes from the field, 11 assists off of him as the three at the other end is no good, out of the hands of Elijah Nix. A rare offensive rebound for Lincoln, trying to reset Garita. Trapped on the baseline, going to try to force one, or he whip it up top, deflected on the way, but able to make it to Cleveland with 8 to shoot. Knippel all over him, trying to drive on Malawach, left it up top, deflected. It came to Hudson, 2 to shoot, put it up and hit it. Boy, that was a ragged-looking possession, but it worked out for Lincoln. He's got 10, 45-30.
The fact that they've been able to hit over 50% of their shots is really a big reason why they've been able to hold their own in this game.
Flag couldn't hit three at the other end. Malawach to the deck trying to save the offensive rebound, and on the alternating possession on the tie-up, that'll give it back to Lincoln. We mentioned the 11 assists already for John Shire's group. Cooper Flag has more than half of them. He's got six. Not surprising with everything he can do on the floor. Last year, Montverde averaging nearly 17 points a game, had four assists per game, three blocks. We've seen the defense here today.
You know, by the way, their team was 33-0 and won the Prep National Championship.
At Montverde. As Littles lead it by 15 with 4:40 to play in the half. Up top, it's Garita. Sends one over to the left and Hudson. He's their leading scorer with 10. Talking about Hudson, now Sorber gets a touch. We're down to 13 to shoot. They're working up top with Nix. Now bounce pass to the right baseline. Sorber faces up on Malawach. Can't hit a jumper. Rebound controlled by Cooper Flag. Oh, and he can lead the break too if he needs to. Reaching in is Nix, and finally the whistle goes. That'll be his second foul, and now we'll walk to the other end to see Cooper shoot a 1-1.
Nix was
or
determined.
Two shots, I should say, as they're in the double bonus now.
Nix was determined not to let him lead the fast break that time, just hounded him after he got the rebound, but Cooper unfazed by the attention and just waited for the foul.
The only thing that has slightly slowed him down has been foul difficulty. The two early fouls that saw him on the bench for about 5 minutes here in the first half. He still played 11 minutes as the free throw is good.
So what is
he's
that? 13 points in 11 minutes?
Yeah.
It's not a bad ratio.
Well, Khan sitting out there with 15 points in 14 minutes. Second attempt. Can take the lead back to 17. Didn't get the roll. And the rebound inside for Cleveland and Lincoln. So 46-30 as we approach 4 minutes to play in the half. Up top, Jackson. Drifting to the right. Lobs it into the arms of Sorber. Deflected by Proctor, taken away. What a theft, and now he'll lead the break. Two on one, kick it to the right. Foster a three. Too strong. Offensive rebound, Malawach. Triple teamed and fouled by Hudson reaching in. That'll be his second, and more free throws after the timeout. Let's take a break. 3:55 to go in our opening half. It's Duke 46 and Lincoln 30.
At Reed's Jewelers, we know that the rules of engagement were made to be broken. So don't settle for the first ring you see in the case. When you put a ring on it, make the moment your own with something that's just as unique as your love. Whether you're going big, keeping it subtle, or finding a happy medium, we're here to help you say I do with a one-of-a-kind design. Because doing things your way is what makes them mean everything. Reed's Jewelers, an official partner of Blue Devil Sports. Visit your local Reed's Jewelers in-store or online at Reed's.com to chat with an expert.
Follow the Blue Devils on and off the hardwood at Duke MBB. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and more. This is Duke Basketball from Learfield.
Make me feel better. All I wanna know is, can I get a
juicy double patty to make nuggets so crisp? And the fries go to yellow, yeah, McDonald's don't miss. Yeah, order the app or the drive through quick. Yeah,
$5, that's a deal, yeah.
I got McDonald's money. I got McDonald's money.
Today.
Hey fans, this is Wayne Cook, co-host of College Sports Now. We're breaking down all the action from around the country every week during the football season. We'll look beyond the box score and keep our finger on the pulse of college football from September all the way to the national championship game in January. Listen all season long on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you'd love to get your podcasts. And be sure to follow along on Twitter at CSNowTweets.
Blue Devils by 16, 46-30 against Lincoln University. Exhibition game number one on the hardwood, 3:55 to go in the first half. Kyle Schasberger here to tell you what's coming up at halftime. We'll check the entire Week 8 scoreboard in college football in the ACC and top 25 games to note. Everything in the ACC has reached halftime. Most of the early window games have reached intermission. 10th-ranked Clemson leads 17-10 over Virginia, and 6th-ranked Miami leads at Louisville 24-17. Get you a score between Wake Forest, UConn, and more coming up at halftime, as well as highlights and stats from our first half, where Con Knipple leads everyone with 15 points in scoring. David.
All right. Thank you very much, Kyle. As we head to the other end to shoot free throws for the Blue Devils out of the timeout, it'll be Kaman Malawash shooting a pair. Of course, the talented young man out of the South Sudan has been playing basketball all that long, but when you hear about the mentorship of Lou Aldang, obviously played in the Olympics this summer over in Paris, and some of the comparisons you hear, very impressive. You start hearing Joel Embiid's name thrown around, and Malawash has said one of the biggest influences on him has been watching Giannis. Not a bad guy to compare yourself to. And we're talking earlier about Cooper just scratching the surface. I think you could say the same thing about Malawash.
You can, and also when you're talking about those two guys, two of the youngest players in college basketball this year. You mentioned Cooper won't be turning 18 until December, and Malawash just turned 18 a couple of weeks ago. So they're the two amongst the top five youngest players in college basketball this year, but so talented, and certainly looking forward to seeing how they grow and develop with age.
Malawash's first free throw was good. That's his first point of the afternoon. Yeah, as you mentioned it, Cooper's the second youngest player in Division I. Malawash is the fifth youngest player. At the other end of the spectrum is Sion James, who started 107 games this year. That ranks among the top 10 of current Division I players, as the second free throw is good.
Sion coming in from a Tulane, where he was certainly a four-year starter.
48-30 now. Duke by 18 with 3:47 to go in the half. On the right, it's Hudson. A baseline drive on Flagg. Got inside. Dangerous pass, but it came to Sorber trying to finish over Malawash. Flagg got a piece. Blocked, and here's Proctor the other way. Outlet pass on the left. It's Foster. Thought about a three. Instead, he'll drive to the left baseline. Got inside. Back up top. Knipple to the left. Deflected, but it came to Tyrese Proctor. Plenty of time. 18 to shoot. On the drive. Into the paint. Whips it to the right. Knipple. Thought about it again. Instead, he'll drive this time. Lob it up to Malawash. Couldn't finish. Trying to get his own rebound, but Cleveland has it for Lincoln. And the other way comes Hudson. Behind the back with a dribble. Gets a screen set by Sorber. Weaving through some traffic. To the left it goes into the hands of Chase Jackson. Half the shot clock is gone as they work it along the left sideline. Sorber, a handoff for Cleveland. Jumps up from 18 and rattles around and drops. He's got 7, 48-32 as we go under 3 minutes to play in the half. Foster for Cooper Flagg up top. Waiting, whips it inside Knipple. One dribble, spinning, looking for help. Lobs it back up top for Flagg. He'll drive with 17 to shoot. Pull up from 8 feet and miss it. And the rebound for Cleveland. And for Cooper, that is just his second miss from the field. Meanwhile, at the other end, spinning inside and getting it blocked by Malawash is Garita. And out of there with it is Knipple. In transition, Cooper Flagg into the paint already. Spins, goes up, and couldn't hit. Rattled around, hit the bracket, the backboard, the rim a couple of different times and came out. And we're going to get another timeout taken by Lincoln with 2:20 to play in the half. That's going to leave them with just one the rest of the way. We'll break for 30 with the Blue Devils up by 16.
For any surface in every season, Continental Tire is the smart choice in tires. From ultra-high performance tires like the Extreme Contact Sport 02, the passenger touring tires, to all-terrain light truck tires like the Terrain Content AT, Continental has a tire that gives you confidence no matter the road conditions. Whether you're looking for summer, all-season, or winter tires, Continental Tire has something to fit your needs. Visit ContinentalTire.com to find your ideal tire. Continental Tire, a proud partner of the Duke Blue Devils.
So a timeout taken by Lincoln with 2:20 to play here in the first half. And the Blue Devils leading by 16, 48-32. Gives us a chance to tell you the Blue Devil basketball is brought to you in part by Coca-Cola. Tackle game day with the great taste of Coke Zero Sugar. Is it the best Coke ever? Try and decide. David Shumate alongside John Roth. John Rose, our producer and engineer. Back inside our network studios is Kyle Schassberger. Great to have you with us as we start to get things underway on the basketball side of things. That countdown to craziness. First exhibition game here today. Next Sunday evening, we'll get together again for a game against Arizona State. Our coverage will get underway at 6 o'clock leading up to a 7 o'clock tip in the Brotherhood Run. Should be a fun night next Sunday night with Bobby Hurley coming back.
I think it's going to be an intense night as well, to be honest.
So we get a foul on Caleb Foster defending up top.
I just know how competitive both the head coaches are, regardless of the setting. It's going to be for charity, but they're going to be going at each other.
Well, it's funny you mentioned that. We had our initial preseason edition of the Fast Break with head coach Sean Shire a little more than a week ago now, and I kind of asked him, because it is preseason in those types of games, because sometimes in those close scrimmages you hear about, they're working on situational stuff, different lineups. I said, how do you approach it with a team like Arizona State, as it'll be Hudson at the line shooting free throws and missed the front end of the 1-1. And he said, well, yeah, that's a piece of it, but I also know me and I know our players, and once the game starts, you want to win.
I know the guy at the other bench too, and he definitely wants to win as well.
As Proctor goes inside it and knocked out of his hands, so that should be fun. And then we'll be about a week away from the start of the regular season, with Maine coming in here on November 4th, a Monday night, for a 7 o'clock tip. Knipple for Sion James. 16-point cushion as we go under 2 minutes to play in the half. James at the top of the key. Gets a screen from Malawach. Sends it to the right. Proctor. Open and around a couple of different times and down from three-point land. Tyrese Proctor's into double figures. He's got 10, and it's 51-32.
Took the full tour and got Blue Devils 3.
About 90 seconds to play until the break. Hudson off of a screen. Weaving through some traffic. Lobs it over to the right. Into the arms of Chase Jackson. Looking for some help. Sends it to Cleveland. 10 to shoot. Knipple defending him, trying to drive the baseline. Steps back from 18, and the rainbow wouldn't go. The rebound for Sion James. A chance to take the lead beyond 20 for the first time today. Proctor on the drive into the paint. Back up top. James, whistle blocking foul on that initial drive for Proctor. Doesn't matter if it's a shooting foul or not, because the Blue Devils are in the double bonus. It does matter that Cleveland just picked up his third foul, and Proctor will shoot two. The Blue Devils at the free throw line already 9 out of 13 in this game that, you know, sometimes you see it a little choppy in the preseason, has seen 22 fouls called already with still a minute 12 to play in the first half. And the first for Tyrese here at the line is good. And give the Blue Devils credit. I'm going from memory here, but I think at one point the fouls were 7-1 or 7-2 called on Duke versus called on Lincoln. And now, since then, the Blue Devils have only been whistled for two. And as we said, now it's 13 that have been called on the Lions, as the second free throw for Proctor is good and the lead goes to 21.
Certainly, we remember that the fouls for the Blue Devils front-loaded in the first few minutes of this contest of that number.
As Hudson brings it across, sends one over to the right. Toa sends it back up top for Garita. Final minute of the opening half. Duke up 53-32. On the right, looking for space is Toa. Already down to 10 to shoot. Garita spinning. Proctor all over him. Hands it off. Toa with 7-6. Proctor has him. Drives. Goes into the paint. Tough two. High off the window. Good and a foul. So Manny Toa has his first points of the day. And the foul is on Tyrese Proctor, and that's his first. We get another look. He's pretty close to going straight up. But it'll be Toa with a chance for a three-point play. Touch how well the Blue Devils have been shooting the basketball. Lincoln over 45% as the free throw is no good. Malawach clears the miss. His seventh rebound. They're 13-28 from the field, but just 1 of 6 from outside. And now the Blue Devils are going to take that use it or lose it timeout with 41.4 to go until the break. We'll break for 30 one more time with Duke up 19.
With all these new winners at the North Carolina Education Lottery Winners Club, we need to decide who's in charge.
We need a top prize winner.
We need someone who's good with words, like us crossword winners.
If elected leader, I will extend the hours during which all winners can use the diamond-encrusted hot tub.
Yes. New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets are packed with $370 million in total prizes. The Winners Club awaits. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning range from 1 in 3.04 to 4.31. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
41.4 to play in the half. The Blue Devils up 53-34 in these exhibition games. A lot of times you want to look at situational stuff, and I think that is what John Shire is doing here. You see so much of the analytics have come from the professional ranks, particularly the NBA, and crept down into the college game. And at least in my mind, you start thinking about a two-for-one opportunity here if you can get a quick look and then perhaps get another possession before the end of the half.
probably that's why he would call this timeout, just to get his club a little experience in this kind of situation in a game environment. Certainly they do these kind of things in practice all the time when there's nobody in the stands and nobody watching. But right now, a lot of people are watching. Let's see how we handle it.
Gillis to inbound it along the right sideline. Looking in the corner, not there, so now Knipple has it. To the left, there's Tyrese Proctor. Now they're just going to run some offense. Here's James. Back up top, Tyrese has it. Lincoln's gone zone. James on the right. Back up top, Tyrese. He'll take a deep three and hit it. Tyrese Proctor has 15 and the lead back to 22. 56-34. Shot clock off now. 20 seconds to play in the half. On the right, it's Hudson. Looking to drive Proctor, got to the baseline. Hudson sends it up top. They're going to try a three with Coates in use. That's short and at least 10 seconds for the Blue Devils to work with. Chance to add to a 22-point lead. 5 seconds to go in the half. Proctor goes inside. Back up top. Gillis will launch. Too strong. Malawach at the buzzer. It wouldn't go on the tap with the right hand. And that'll chase us to halftime. So the Blue Devils leading by 22, 56-34 at the break. Three in double figures led by Knipple. He has 15. Flagg has 13. Proctor with 15 as well. And at the break, it's a 22-point lead, 56-34, as we send it to the studio. And Kyle,
thanks so much, David. Coming up at halftime, we'll check the out-of-town scoreboard. Well, week 8 scoreboard reset across all of college football. Got a trio of ACC games currently going on. A slew of others coming up later. Spotlighted by none other, though, biggest game of the day, Texas and Georgia. Coming up in Austin, a preview there as well. 56-34, our halftime score. Highlights and stats upcoming. It's halftime at Cameron Indoor Stadium, and the halftime coverage starts after this.
With all these new winners at the North Carolina Education Lottery Winners Club, we need to decide who's in charge.
We need a top prize winner.
We need someone who's good with words, like us crossword winners.
If elected leader, I will extend the hours during which all winners can use the diamond-encrusted hot tub.
Yes!
New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets are packed with $370 million in total prizes. The Winners Club awaits. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning range from 1 in 3.04 to 4.31. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
Steel gives you more than just reliable landscaping tools. Steel gives you battery-powered equipment trusted by the pros. From mowers and blowers to chainsaws and trimmers, take on your outdoor space with a name pros trust. Right now, save $20 on the BGA 57 battery blower set, including the AK-20 battery and AL-101 battery charger. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. Available for a limited time at participating dealers while supplies last.
Duke plays here.
Flying in, reverses it, up and in for two.
This is the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
You can always say good morning, but when you're about to enjoy McDonald's breakfast, you say good morning.
Now, get two sausage burritos, hash browns, and a medium hot coffee for just $5 at participating McDonald's.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I feel happy, I'm in and out real fast.
I feel happy, nothing stops are a blast.
I love today and get in on the fun. The little people stop your spirits have begun.
Which schools will take home the prestigious Learfield Director's Cup as the top college athletic programs for the 2024-25 college athletic season? You can follow the standings of your favorite team or alma mater at L Director's Cup on Twitter and online at thedirectorscup.com. Trophies will be awarded in June 2025 to the winning institutions in all college sports divisions. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics.
On the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield, welcome to the Duke Basketball Halftime Report. Coming up, we'll break down the game's first 20 minutes, update scores from the ACC and the top 25, and preview the second half. Our halftime coverage begins inside the Learfield Network studios. Here's Kyle Schatzberger.
56-34 is our exhibition score. Duke on top of Lincoln University after 20 minutes of play inside Cameron Indoor Stadium. Kyle Schatzberger with you inside Studio 21. One other exhibition till coming up a week from tomorrow. That's against Bobby Hurley's Arizona State Sun Devils before Duke tips off the season on November 4th. Let's go ahead and set the out-of-town scoreboard for you, get you updated on some of the scores across all of college football, starting first in the ACC. 10th-ranked Clemson at home against Virginia. The Tigers looking to move to 6-1 on the year.
And up off the middle he goes, pushing it forward, looking for the end zone. Did he find it? Give me a signal. Waiting. He'll dig in there. Where does he come up with a football? Touchdown. Moffa's second rushing touchdown of the game. And it's Clemson by 6 now over Virginia, 16-10.
It's Don Munson in the waning moments of the second half. Game was tied at 3 after one quarter. Early stages of the third. It's now 24-10 as the Tigers have added another touchdown. Clemson on top of Virginia. Wake Forest leading UConn 20-12. Huskies just scored a touchdown through the air midway point of the third quarter. 6th-ranked Miami leads Louisville as they get ready to embark upon the second half in Derby City, 24-17. Top 25 scores to note. 16th-ranked Indiana, 28-Nebraska, 7. They're just underway in the third quarter. 10-3 Auburn has finally scored the game's first touchdown early in the third quarter in Como against 19th-ranked Missouri. Tigers with the 7-point lead. That's Auburn, the visitors at Mizzou. 9-12 mark of the third quarter. 23rd-ranked Army starting to run away with it against ECU.
Reed in the game is a slot left. Daly waiting, has the ball. Now runs with it. Spindle at the 22-yard line. Runs left to the 10-yard line and cuts at the 5, and he's in for the touchdown. What a move by Bryson Daly in the backfield. A 360.
That's Rich DeMarco from Learfield. One of 4 touchdowns on the afternoon for Daly. 31-0 is the score early in the third. Bryson Daly, the Cadets QB, has got 24 total touchdowns on the season. Among the big ones coming up later today, 7th-ranked Alabama, 11th-ranked Tennessee, 3:30 start, 24th-ranked Michigan, 22nd-ranked Illinois also will kick off then. Then tonight, top 5 showdown, 5th-ranked Georgia, and Kirby Smart will try to solve the riddle that is top-ranked Texas and undefeated Quinn Ewers.
His awareness, like there's nothing that he sees he hasn't seen. You know, quarterback, you get confidence by playing the position. You're not going to have some guy that just doesn't play and go out there and play great. He's
at 7:30 start in Austin between the Bulldogs and the Longhorns. Again, our halftime score 56-34. Duke leading Lincoln. A couple of the highlights when we return to moment on the Blue Devil Sports Network.
Hey, Blue Devil fans, cue the shine and savings. The new Zips Car Wash app is available for download. Keeping your ride sparkling clean has never been more rewarding. Get the free Zips app and earn points for every in-app purchase, including memberships. Then turn those points into free car wash rewards. Download the app today, and your first car wash is free. Visit the Apple App Store or Google Play Store and search Zips Car Wash now.
The passion, the excitement, the tradition. This is Duke Basketball from Learfield.
Receipt double padded, a McNugget so crisp, and the fries go to yellow, yeah, McDonald's don't miss. $5, that's a deal, yeah.
I got McDonald's money, I got McDonald's money.
Bennington, as well as Cobalt Boats. Overbeam Marine also offers the largest selection of parts in the region, along with full-service facilities at their 2 locations. Stop by or give them a call at 252-586-3593 or online at overbeammarine.com. Overbeam Marine. Don't let adventure pass you by.
It's bow time. It's not just football season. It's tailgate season. And that includes every kind of football, whether it's got goalkeepers or goalposts.
The kick is good!
Because it doesn't matter where or how you tailgate. When you've got crispy chicken and fluffy buttermilk biscuits from Bojangles, your tailgate is better than great. It's legendary. Head to Bojangles and order your tailgate box with boldly seasoned chicken, fixins, biscuits, and legendary iced tea today. It's bow time.
This copyrighted broadcast is an exclusive presentation of Learfield under the broadcasting rights granted by Duke University. Reuse of this presentation is prohibited without the expressed written consent of Duke University and Learfield. Announcers are provided by Learfield and approved by Duke University.
56-34, Blue Devils on top of the Lions of Lincoln University in this exhibition matchup from Cameron. Kyle Shasper with you again inside Studio 21. Take you through a few of the highlights. Malik Brown, one of the transfers that the Blue Devils were able to secure in the offseason from Syracuse, made his impact known early and often.
Meanwhile, Cooper had been out since the 15:02 mark with those two fouls. As they lob it in for Sorber, deflected, stolen. Gill has got a piece, and now a run out for Brown to throw it down.
And that was Gillis, a Purdue transfer, helping to set up Brown for one of three dunks. He was perfect from the floor with six first half points. Cooper flagged, though, the most highly touted recruit, number one freshman entering the season. He scored much of the first half, much of his points coming in the later stages of the second half. He finished with 13 points on 4 of 7 shooting, but dialed it up inside and outside.
Back up top, Knippel has it, looking to drive. Got to the right side of the paint, back up top for a Cooper flag, 3, and he hits it. Cooper now with 7, and the lead as big as it's been all day at 8, 27-19.
One of 9 makes from downtown. 5 of those came from another freshman in Con Knippel.
An outlet pass for Caleb Foster, streaming across midcourt left to right. Whips it to the corner for Knippel. His 3 is good. Con Knippel is feeling it. He's 5 of 7 from outside, and Lincoln wants a timeout.
Duke 9 of 19 overall from downtown, 55% from the floor. They lead 56-34. Other news out of the ACC a couple of days ago, Tony Bennett announced his retirement effective immediately from Virginia. Ron Sanchez will be the interim head coach for the Hoos season. Blue Devils up big at the break. John Rolfe with more of the first half numbers. We return after this.
Let me grab my car keys and we'll roll.
We still going to that new bar downtown?
Yeah, it's supposed to be fun. Lexi, give me driving directions from home to downtown bar district.
Autocorrect. Suggest Uber. Pick up. Home. Drop off downtown bar district.
No, I'm driving.
Suggest the Metro bus. Departing in 12 minutes.
Point taken, Lexi. We'll grab a ride.
If you drink, don't drive. Decide to ride. Brought to you in partnership by Anheuser-Busch, Mothers Against Drunk Driving, and Uber.
You're listening to Duke Basketball on the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
Think about the last time you moved. Remember how you said you'd never do it alone again? We know moving is tough, but at Two Men and a Truck, we make it easy. No matter the move, big or small, we'll make it a smooth one. We're the movers who care and we'll prove it with our 96% referral rate and courteous background check movers. We're local and affordable, and we can help at a price that won't make you wish you'd done it on your own. When you're ready, give us a call or find us online for a free estimate at twomenandatruck.com.
Enjoying the game but not the drink being spilled down your back or the foam finger poking you in the face? Well, head to the concession stand, grab a Lindy's Italian Ice, and take a 6-ounce vacation. A 6-ounce cup of lemon Italian Ice will make you feel like you're swaying in a hammock and the only thing in your face is a cool, salty breeze. That ought to have you refreshed. Now get your head back in the game and start belting out Blue and White with the youthful exuberance of the freshman behind you. Yes, the same one that keeps spilling his drink down your back. Lindy's Italian Ice. Have an ice day.
Blue Devils up 22 at the half, 56-34 over Lincoln in an exhibition game. John Roth with you from Cameron Indoor Stadium. Let's check out some of the halftime numbers that are presented by Steel. Pro-level performance at work and at home. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. 3 double-figure scores for Duke in the opening half. 2 freshman starters did it. Con Knippel with 15 on 5 three-point shots, and Cooper Flagg with 12 on 3 twos and 1 3. Cooper also led the way in assists for the Blue Devils with 6 in that half. And then double figures off the bench today. Tyrese Proctor didn't start, but played 14 minutes and got 15 points, including a good performance at the free throw stripe. Other scores for Duke in the half: 6 for Brown, 5 for Foster, and 2 for Malawash. Overall, Duke hit 55% of its shots and knocked down 9 of 19 from three-point range while out-rebounding Lincoln 24-14. One double-figure score for Lincoln. Reggie Hudson hit 5 out of 12 for 10 points. They were 47% from the field for the half. So the Blue Devils up 56-34. We've got the second 20 minutes coming your way right after this. You're listening to Duke Basketball from Learfield.
This is Coke Zero Sugar. Could I be the best Coke ever? Try and taste with your ears. Hear those bubbles? Imagine them tingling on your tongue. Fizzy deliciousness. Listen to that cascading liquid. A mouth-watering waterfall. Irresistibly tasty. Zero sugar. Crisp. Refreshing. And ice cold. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Duke Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
We've called a 60-second local break timeout. Then more Duke basketball. You're listening to the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield.
He'll fire, and it's good!
This is Duke head men's basketball coach John Shire. When it comes to keeping our team healthy, we turn to the team at Duke Sports Medicine. We offer full-service sports medicine care at locations throughout the Triangle, where you can see the same experts used by Duke Athletics. Make an appointment or learn more at dukehealth.org/sportsmedicine. Go Duke!
The crowd loves that.
Which schools will take home the prestigious Learfield Director's Cup as the top college athletic programs for the 2024-25 college athletics season? You can follow the standings of your favorite team or alma mater at L Director's Cup on Twitter and online at thedirectorscup.com. Trophies will be awarded in June 2025 to the winning institutions in all college sports divisions. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics.
Off we go to the second half. The Blue Devils leading by 22, 56 to 34 here at Cameron Indoor Stadium. The first of two exhibition games this season. They'll face Arizona State coming up next Sunday night. David Schumate alongside John Roth. John Rose, our producer and engineer. Back inside our network studios is Kyle Schassberger. Great to have you guys with us this afternoon. As John kind of told you the numbers a moment ago, it was a very impressive first half for a couple of freshmen. An experienced guy mixed in the three double-figure scorers, Proctor and Knippel, each with 15. Flag had 13. And as we start the second half, the starters back out there for John Shire, Cooper Flag, Caleb Foster, Malik Brown, Con Knippel, and Sion James. As we'll see, the Blue Devils go right to left here in the second stanza, leading by 22. They have it first. Cooper right into the paint, right back to work. Couldn't get the shot. Offensive rebound, Knippel. And Khan with a fresh 20 sends it back up top for Caleb Foster. Over to the right and Sion James. A baseline drive got airborne. Scooped it with the left hand. No, they fight for the rebound. And this time, able to come up with it is Lincoln with Garita. In transition, Hudson. Awkward shot in the paint. Man, they've hit some tough shots today. Got that one to go, and he's got 12.
They have, and now they're just about to hit 50% for the game here.
56-36, just underway in the second stanza. Cooper. At the top of the key, sends it to the left, Knippel. A baseline drive into the paint. Up top, Flag is wide open, and he makes a pay. Cooper hits a three, and he's got 16.
His second three. Khan's got five. The Blue Devils have 10 as a team.
And a 23-point cushion a minute into the second half. Knocked out of the hands of Sorber by Brown, able to collect it again. Now handed off, curling as Hudson. Backs out at the top of the key. Working on the left side of the floor now, trying to drive Brown into a double team. Got rid of it for Sorber from 10 feet. He hits the jumper. So Peter Sorber has six now. He was the MVP of that tournament a year ago they won, as they were the CIAA champs after beating Fayetteville State in the championship game, 54-51. Blue Devils, of course, went to the Elite Eight a year ago. A lot of newcomers this year, though, and Knippel in the left corner can't hit a three. This time, Brown fighting for the rebound is fouled by Sorber. That'll be his third. And of course, this group has lofty expectations of getting back to the Final Four for Blue Devil program. Obviously, that is very familiar with what it takes to get to the Final Four and to win it all with those five national championships, as we already see a substitute coming for Lincoln. Hudson will leave, and into the game comes Chase Jackson, the sophomore out of Teaneck, New Jersey. Littles, by the way, with 19 makes from the field, they now have 14 assists, led by Cooper Flagg with six. He's got it up top again. Three ball around, didn't get the roll. Man, he's just missed a couple, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Knippel along the left baseline. Now, he could easily have 20-plus right now. He's had a couple take the full tour at the right end of the floor. Now that three just ripped out.
And that's basically in playing 15 minutes. So he's a point, looks like a point per minute guy.
For the freshman out of Newport, Maine. So gifted. Jackson across midcourt. 21-point cushion. 2 minutes into the second half. Sorber trying to get rid of it. Brown all over him. Knocked it loose, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by the Blue Devils along the left sideline. We know the head coach of the Blue Devils as well as I think we do. I imagine the conversation in the locker room. While they're pleased at the offensive end, probably wanted to tighten a few things up on the defensive end of the floor, because you said Lincoln shot the ball well in the first half. They made some tough shots. And you do see the Blue Devils coming out and pressuring the ball pretty heavily here to start the second half.
And they also want that to be part of the identity, the main part of the identity of this team. So certainly every time they get a chance to work on making the defense better, they're going to try to take advantage of it.
Amir Moore out there for the first time for Lincoln. He's on the right. They whip it to the left. Three ball is on the way. And it's an air ball out of the hands of Coates and Hughes. Offensive rebound came into the hands of Cleveland, but he can get a shot off before the shot clock expired.
Yeah, obviously with the air ball, it didn't re-trigger the clock, and so it kept on counting down and expired.
Well, Jhené Coates-Hughes was 2 of 15 from 3 a year ago, and that one missed badly. As the Blue Devils bring it across, still leading by 21. Their largest margin today has been 23. Foster can't hit a three. James there to clean it up, flying it off the right to put it off the window for his first field goal. And it's 61-38, 17-25 to go.
Decent amount of second chance points considering they've shot so well. That's 9 for the game.
Is at the top of the key. It's Garita trying to drive flag. Just throws up a prayer off the rim and out, and the rebound for James. It was a prayer because he had to get it over Cooper Flagg and Malawach and really had no chance. Cooper with it now in front of the Duke bench. Up top, Sion James. To the right it goes, and Konkanipal. He'll drive into the paint, pull up, kick up top for James. Around the perimeter goes for Cooper Flagg. Steps through a double team, punches it down, and he's fouled. My goodness.
Cooper Flagg showing the full arsenal here against Lincoln University. He's been inside, he's been outside, he's been passing the ball, he's been blocking shots. Cooper Flagg, a little bit of everything here in his opener.
The foul on Jackson is his first. We've seen the three-point shooting. You start making those. Guys try to crash out, and he's so skilled, goes right by two and then punches it and can't complete the three-point plays. He missed the free throw. Biggest lead of the day at 25, 63 to 38. 3 minutes into the second half. On the right, Cleveland has it now for Lincoln. Off of the screen, set by Garita. Now it works its way around to the left to Chase Jackson. Jackson gets the screen. Shot clock's already down to 6 and 5. Into the left corner it goes. Looking for some space more. I don't think he knows the shot clock is winding down. Just barely got it off. Hit the bracket, missed it. Offensive rebound inside. And Cleveland with a fresh 20. I'm not sure he got it off, but they're going to let it play. Cleveland off of the screen, working his way to the perimeter. Rises up over Sion James, can't hit. The rebound volleyballed off the backboard. Lincoln got it again. Out for Cleveland. Got airborne, tried to feed it inside. Deflected by James, taken away, and then he's fouled by Cleveland, and that's number 4.
Blue Devils fighting for the rebound to get that possession back.
We're starting to open it up on the glass, too. 29-19, the advantage right now.
And obviously the defense has been pretty solid to start this half with already 2 possessions that should have ended in shot clock violations. That one didn't, but easily could have.
Gillis and Proctor back on the floor. Malawach out there along with Konkanipal and Cooper Flagg now. Flagg on the drive, left side of the paint, got inside, whipped it to the right corner. Konkanipal can't hit the three. Offensive rebound, Malawach. He's got cutters on the right. How about Kahn for the right hand punch? My goodness, what a finish.
Delighting the Cameron Crazies in their freshman debut. The Blue Devils up 65-38.
Hudson a three at the top of the key. Quiets the crowd oh so briefly, 65-41. So he can shoot threes and rise up like that. My, oh my. Konkanipal has it now. Into the paint, knocked loose, stolen. Konkanipal diving to the deck trying to get it back. He's going to be whistled for a foul, reaching it on Hudson. That's his second.
I think we'll take that foul, though.
Let's take a timeout. 15:25 to go. Little's having some fun. Up by 24, 65-41.
Every day in the U.S., more than 9 people are killed and 1,000 injured in crashes involving a distracted driver. You can't control other motorists, but you can control how you operate your vehicle. Avoid distractions while driving, like texting or checking social media. Brought to you by Trusted Choice Independent Insurance Agents of North Carolina. Learn more at trustedchoice.com/goduke.
Hey, Blue Devil fans, cue the shine and savings. The new Zips Car Wash app is available for download. Keeping your ride sparkling clean has never been more rewarding. Get the free Zips app and earn points for every in-app purchase, including memberships. Then turn those points into free car wash rewards. Download the app today, and your first car wash is free. Visit the Apple App Store or Google Play Store and search Zips Car Wash now.
Hey, Duke fans, want to enhance your game day experience? Poetry Finance, official digital banking partner of Duke Athletics, is here to help. With Poetry, managing your finances is a breeze. Just download the Poetry app to discover how Poetry Finance can help you. Poetry Finance, write your own future. Start now. Financial tools for everyone. Let us help you get started at poetryfinance.com. That's poetryfinance.com.
Explosive plays under the rim have helped Duke to a 65-41 lead over Lincoln University, a 24-point advantage. And it was a pair of dunks from a couple of the highly anticipated and talented freshmen now on this squad.
Up top, Zion James. To the right, it goes in Konkanipal. He'll drive into the paint, pull up, kick up top for James. Around the perimeter goes for Cooper Flagg. Steps through a double team, punches it down, and he's fouled. Flagg on the drive, left side of the paint, got inside, whipped it to the right corner. Konkanipal can't hit the three. Offensive rebound, Malawach. He's got cutters on the right. How about Con for the right hand punch?
65-41. First it was Flagg, then it was Konkanipal. Flagg's got 18. Knipple's got 17. It's all Blue Devils. Almost 5 minutes gone by in the second half. David?
Wow. Those two are going to be special. They already are. 15-25 to go here in the second half. And the Blue Devils up by 24, 65-41. Don't forget that Blue Devil basketball is brought to you in part by Poetry Finance. Write your own future with Poetry. Poetry Finance, official online banking partner of Duke Athletics. And, you know, you heard us say there that there were two cutters on the right, so to speak of. And you know, it kind of speaks, I think, John, to the versatility of this team and the nightmare trying to get ready to play Duke. I think it's going to be this year because, take your pick. Okay, you're going to try to take away Cooper Flagg. Well, now here's Knipple coming wide open to punch it down.
Yeah, I know. That versatility is really a blessing on this team. I remember one fast break opportunity in the first half where Tyrese Proctor was coming down the middle of the court, and he got around the free throw line. He had three actually good, solid options to pick from to finish the play. So there's a lot going on with this team offensively.
65-41 as we approach 15 minutes to play in the half. Hudson has it for Lincoln. Sends it over to the right. Facing up Moore. Got tied up by Konkanipal. Another defensive play. And on the alternating possession, it'll go over to the Blue Devils. Actually, it's going to stay with Lincoln, excuse me, as the Blue Devils had it first here in the second half. But now the Blue Devils own the arrows. We see Darren Harris come back in. Saw him briefly in the first half. The freshman out of Herndon, Virginia. Of course, he hails from St. Paul the Sixth, PVI, they affectionately call it. Both he and Patrick Gungba, who's been dealing with a bit of an injury. We won't see him today as Hudson hits a 10-footer just inside the free throw line. He's got 17.
PV6, the national runner-up last year. That's the team that Cooper Flagg's squad beat in the prep national championship game.
As Cooper Flagg couldn't hit inside, but the last touched on the way out by Toa. We'll stay with the Blue Devils at 20 to shoot. Proctor to cue it in. Waits gets it for Malawach, right back for Tyrese on the left corner. Drives, lobs, Malawach to throw it down. And that wasn't easy. It was a little bit low. I had to catch it kind of under the rim, take it above the rim, and plenty of strength to punch it down.
Not a perfect pass. Still counts as an assist because of the way Malawach was able to handle it.
Gaman out there wearing a glove on his left hand. They've cut it so the fingers can get loose. It's a football glove he's wearing out there. You see some of the offensive linemen wide receivers wear from Andy Diaz as they fight for the rebound off the missed shot, and Malawach has it for the Blue Devils. A chance to run ahead, Everett Gillis. Left side three. Too strong. Offense rebound. Harris right back to Cooper to lay it in. The Blue Devils flowing right now. And they are starting to pull away from Lincoln at 69-43.
And really good basketball play from Harris that time, getting the rebound and feeding it off balance to his teammate before he even hit the ground.
And Cooper Flagg knocks one out of bounds as they're trying to get it back up top for Amir Moore. Think about that glove, John. It looks sharp down there on Malawach.
Now that you get an up-close look at it, yeah, it, that just adds another element of intimidation in my book. But, yeah.
Like I said, they've cut it so the fingers can come out so he can play with the skill that he's shown today. Hit a couple of free throws, had that dunk a moment ago. He'll head out to get a breather. Set the five on the floor. It's Cooper Flagg, Mason Gillis, Tyrese Proctor, Malik Brown, and Darren Harris. Janae Coates-Sinews has it for Lincoln and gets rid of it for Hudson. Hudson crossing over, eight to shoot, into the paint on Brown, can't finish, and the rebound for Cooper Flagg. A chance to run four on three to left. Proctor, weaving into the paint, put it up, no, and he's fouled and will shoot two. Janae Coates-Sinews will pick up his first, and two free throws coming for Tyrese Proctor, and that's another thing. There's so many things that stem from the depth of this team this year. You know, because of limited bodies the last couple of years, a lot of that because of injuries, we didn't really see particularly late in the season, John. Yes, they would break off of a turnover, stuff like that, but not the breakneck pace we're seeing here today. When they get the rebound, it is beep, beep to the other end of the floor.
And that's one of the elements they really want to incorporate more, as you mentioned, than they have the last couple of years. And they certainly have the personnel to do it. A lot of ball handlers and a lot of guys who can run the floor.
As we see Isaiah Evans come in for the first time, the freshman out of Fayetteville. He was electric during Countdown to Craziness. Had seven in the second scrimmage, eight in the first, 15 in total, as Proctor hits both free throws.
One of the McDonald's All-Americans when you look at accolades out of this recruiting class.
Speaking of guys who can fill it up, wasn't it 62 he had?
In a prep playoff game as a junior.
Here's another steal by Brown, another chance to run, four on three. Evans to the left, there's Proctor in the corner. Little shoulder shake, into the paint he goes, rises up, and hits again. Tyrese Proctor now with 19, and all of a sudden the lead balloons to 30. 73-43, the Blue Devils have scored the last six.
Proctor a healthy 5 out of 7 from the floor with a couple threes and good work at the line.
As Hudson backs out up top, crosses over, jumps up from 18, rattles it home. Reggie Hudson, tough shot maker for them. He's got 19, I should say, to lead the way for Lincoln. 73-45. Working on the left, it's Proctor. Whips it to the corner. Gillis a little bit too far out in front of his reach and out of bounds and over to the Lions.
Rare turnover for the Blue Devils. Just the eighth of the game. I think just the second of this half.
So 73-45 with 12:38 to go. As across midcourt comes Hudson. Cross over to the right. Waiting, sizing it up, trying to drive Gillis. Cut off, fades away from 15. Can't hit that one. The rebound for Harris. Darren, a hit ahead for Brown. Cross court, deflected, trying to get it to Gillis in the right corner, but getting a hand on it was Garita. He'll stay with the Blue Devils along the left baseline with 24 to shoot. As we'll see Young come back in, as will Caleb Foster, the sophomore out of Harrisburg, North Carolina. Tyrese Proctor will come out. He has 19. Cooper Flagg is the leading scorer with 20. Off the inbound, Brown. And now Caleb Foster has it again. Gillis whips it to the left. There's Harris. He wants to drive into the paint. Rises up. Got it blocked out of bounds. It'll stay on this end of the floor. I think it was Garita who got a piece. And with 15 to shoot, the Blue Devils can reset. 12:13 to go. Blue Devils already with 5 blocks in this game.
3 by Flagg.
35-19, 36-19. Now the rebounding advantage is Gillis is fouled along the left baseline. That'll be on Freddie Young, and that's his fourth. On a jumper from 10 feet out. And now Gillis to the free throw line, where the Blue Devils are 13 of 18 today. And gives us a chance to remind you that Food Line is the proud sponsor of the Score to Give More program. For every free throw made by the Blue Devils this year, Food Line will make a donation to help our neighbors in need. Last year alone, Food Line donated 30,000 meals to support our local community. As the first free throw is good for Gillis here, one more to come. It's his first point of the afternoon. Blue Devils sitting on 74 right now with 12:11 to go. You were mentioning about the offense and all the different weapons the Blue Devils have. And visiting with John Shire a couple weeks ago, is the second free throw is on the way and good. He was talking about the preseason. A lot of the focus has been on defense, and he kind of wryly said, I know we can score. And we've seen that here this afternoon. On the left, Hudson, defended by Gillis. Working with a right-hand dribble. Crossed over. No room to shoot. Had to get rid of it to the right. Three ball on the way from Young. Missed badly off the backboard. Isaiah Evans being held, but able to come up with a rebound anyway. Garita had him wrapped around the waist. Isaiah said, I don't care. I'm going to get the basketball. And here's Caleb in transition. Into the paint he goes. Rises up. Put it off the window. No. And the rebound into the hands of Garita. So 75-45 our score with 11.5 minutes to go. Long hit ahead pass. Nice catch in traffic by Coach St. Hughes, but it was knocked out of his hands out of bounds. And it'll be Lincoln basketball when we come back. 11:33 to go in Cameron. All Blue Devils up 75-45.
Are you ready to show your Duke pride wherever you go? Visit shop.duke.edu, your one-stop online store for all things Duke. From the latest apparel to must-have accessories, Duke University Stores has it all. Whether you're a student, alumni, or fan, shop.duke.edu has something for everyone. Get your hands on exclusive Duke gear today. Shop conveniently online at shop.duke.edu, where real Duke fans shop.
For the latest in news, notes, and special content, head to goduke.com. This is the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield.
It's bow time.
It's not just football season. It's tailgate season. And that includes every kind of football, whether it's got goalkeepers or goalposts.
The kick is good!
Because it doesn't matter where or how you tailgate. When you've got crispy chicken and fluffy buttermilk biscuits from Bojangles, your tailgate is better than great. It's legendary. Head to Bojangles and order your tailgate box with boldly seasoned chicken, fixins, biscuits, and legendary iced tea today.
It's bow time.
Enjoying the game but not the drink being spilled down your back or the foam finger poking you in the face? Well, head to the concession stand, grab a Lindy's Italian Ice, and take a 6-ounce vacation. A 6-ounce cup of lemon Italian Ice will make you feel like you're swaying in a hammock and the only thing in your face is a cool, salty breeze. That ought to have you refreshed. Now get your head back in the game and start belting out blue and white with the youthful exuberance of the freshman behind you. Yes, the same one that keeps spilling his drink down your back. Lindy's Italian Ice. Have an ice day.
Welcome back to Cameron Indoor, where Duke holds a 30-point lead on Lincoln in an exhibition basketball game, 75-45. Let's peruse some of the in-game stats presented by Steel. Pro-level performance at work and at home. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. The Blue Devils, three top scorers in this contest. The freshman Cooper Flagg with 20. The junior Tyrese Proctor with 19, and the freshman Con Knipple with 17. Blue Devils have had 10 three-point shots go down so far in this contest, and overall are hitting 50% from the floor. The assist numbers have been quite attractive as well. 17 on 25 made baskets, and the rebounding margin has become overwhelming. They are claiming the glass to the tune of 37-20 over Lincoln. Lincoln has one double-figure score, and he's been pretty strong. Hudson with 19 on 9 out of 18 shooting. He was an HBCU All-American last year and showing why here today at Cameron. Overall, though, they've only hit two from beyond the arc. They haven't yet had a free throw here in the second half. 5 out of 9 in the first, and overall they're hitting 44%. So Blue Devils, it's not been a high turnover game. Lincoln's committed 9, but the Blue Devils have turned that into 18 points off of turnovers as another element. They can score the ball, but they can also score the ball off their defense.
And off the inbound, the Lincoln going to work, trailing by 30 with 11:28 to go. On the drive, Hudson, he's had a nice afternoon, but another rejection by Flagg. Got him from behind. Now Cooper in transition, got to the baseline, waits for help. Up top, Malawach, thinking about a three. He almost got it to go. It came out, though, in the rebound for Lincoln. Might have been the only thing missing so far today is the big fella hitting one from outside.
I think that's 4 blocks now for Flagg to go along with all those gaudy offensive statistics.
Can do just about everything, the talented freshman. As facing up is Garita, wants to drive, knocked loose on the way by, but a foul is going to be called on Sion James, and that's his third. Not nearly as many fouls here in the second half as we saw in the first half. The second on the Blue Devils, Lincoln has been whistled for 5. And Lincoln inbound on the baseline, it's Young. waiting, just throws it into no man's land, and it's James there to clean it up and dunk it down with the right hand. Almost like a wideout leaking out for a free run to the end zone. Caught it, looked behind, nobody was there, settled himself, and threw it down. 77-45. It was almost like he was in disbelief how open he was. Meanwhile, at the other end, Hudson reigns in a three at the top of the key. He's got 22 now, and 77-48. Blue Devils with 20 points off of turnovers now. Evans into the paint. Kicks to the corner. Brown back right for Isaiah. And now Cooper sends it around to the left. Sion James to the baseline. Spinning back up top for Cooper Flagg. Drives, backs out. Reloads, goes inside, spins up top. Evans will launch. And the three wouldn't go. Milowatch tapped the rebound, but it's out of bounds into the Blue Devil bench.
Trying to keep it alive for a teammate to rebound, but no one could quite get there. So with 10 minutes to go, it's going to be Lincoln ball.
Blue Devils still right around 50% from the field, 49%, 26-53. They've hit 10 of their 27 threes today and 15-20 at the line. As Hudson pulls from 15 on the right and hits, he's having himself a day. 24 of the 50 for Lincoln. He's the primary ball handler more often than not today. He's been calling his own number. In the left corner, Evans on the drive into the paint. A ball fake, rises up, puts it off the window. No, but he's fouled and will shoot two. And the foul will be on Jhené Coates-Sinous, and that's his second.
I think Hudson's already made more threes in this exhibition game than he had all last season. I think he just made one all last year.
One out of 18, and now he's two out of four. He is not afraid to take a contested shot, I'll put it that way. 11 of 21 today. Some of them have been very difficult amongst the 11 makes as Evans can't hit the first free throw. One more to come. Averaged 28 a year ago, did Isaiah, during his senior year at North Mecklenburg High School. As we see James and Brown come out, Cooper Flagg and Tyrese Proctor return.
He's a guy who had his high school jersey retired. You don't often hear about that, but he wore number zero in high school, and they retired that when he finished.
Gets the second free throw, his first point, makes it 78-50 with 9.5 minutes to go. Hudson across midcourt, working his way through some traffic, got to the free throw line, nearly fell down. Spinning on Proctor, nothing doing. Back up top, Toa, into the paint it goes, nearly sliding the pivot foot as Garrido faces up on Cooper Flagg, rattled around, came out on the jumper. Coates-Sinous going back to work, but he stepped out of bounds along the right baseline, and they turn it over for what will be the 11th time this afternoon. And John Shire is going to take a timeout to talk it over. We'll take it as well. 9:14 to go. The Blue Devils leading 78-50.
For generations, hardworking people have relied on Ford F-Series trucks to help grow businesses, communities, families. A legacy of capability and technology that has made Ford F-Series America's best-selling trucks 47 years straight. This is the next generation of Built Ford Tough. Based on 1977 to 2023 calendar year total sales.
With all these new winners at the North Carolina Education Lottery Winners Club, we need to decide who's in charge.
We need a top prize winner.
We need someone who's good with words, like us crossword winners.
If elected leader, I will extend the hours during which all winners can use the diamond-encrusted hot tub.
Yes.
New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets are packed with $370 million in total prizes. The Winners Club awaits. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning range from 1 in 3.04 to 4.31. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
He'll fire, and it's good!
This is Duquehead men's basketball coach John Shire. When it comes to keeping our team healthy, we turn to the team at Duke Sports Medicine. We offer full-service sports medicine care at locations throughout the Triangle, where you can see the same experts used by Duke Athletics. Make an appointment or learn more at dukehealth.org/sportsmedicine. Go Duke!
The crowd loves that. 14 to go in this one. The Blue Devils in control of 78-50. Don't miss the Duke Basketball Radio Show presented by the Washington Duke Inn and Golf Club. Our next episode comes your way on Wednesday, November 6th. We'll be with you throughout the season. You can catch the show live on WRAL News Plus, 96.5 FM in Durham, and 99.3 FM in Raleigh, and on the Buzz, 620 AM and 1550 AM, and of course across the entire Blue Devil Sports Network. There'll be plenty to talk about in that one after the game against Arizona State. And then, of course, the regular season opener Monday night against Maine, November 4th. That'll be a 7 o'clock tip here, Cameron. And, John, it kickstarts a sprint to Christmas, so to speak, for this group.
True.
A very difficult schedule. Six-game stretch from November 12th to December 4th. The Blue Devils are going to play four teams ranked in the preseason AP Top 25. They've got Arizona, true road game, the return game for the game that was played here a year ago. That same trip, they're actually going to stay out west. The following week, go over to Las Vegas and play Kansas there before coming home the next week and facing Auburn. And don't forget about the Champions Classic before all of that down in Atlanta against Kentucky. And then you get an ACC play and two road games with Louisville and Georgia Tech before Christmas. That means there's going to be three true road games for the Blue Devils before Christmas for the first time in more than 30 years. You got to go all the way back to the 1990-91 season.
Yeah, usually there may be like one true road game before Christmas, and a lot of times that's in the old ACC Big Ten Challenge every other year. So certainly the Blue Devils are going to get a taste of what it's going to be like on the road this year, and where everybody's always gunning for them anyway, but get an early baptism in that aspect of the schedule. And those are going to be some pretty interesting road games, beginning with that one out in Arizona early in November.
So the Blue Devils are out there with Tyrese Proctor, Cooper Flagg, Kamon Maluach, Con Knipple, and Mason Gillis. Cooper has it on the right, going to try a three, too strong. The rebound for Gillis, another second chance opportunity. To the right it goes, and Con Knipple, a baseline drive. Back up top, Flag, and now around to the left it goes. Gillis in front of his own bench. 10 to shoot, back for Tyrese. Drifts to the left, 8-7. Between the legs, dancing, got into the paint. Kicks to the right, Cooper Flag with 3-2. Into the paint, forced it up, left it short. Offensive rebound, Knipple. A third opportunity. Cooper has it now. To the baseline, Knipple again. Waiting, backing down, into the paint, spins to the left, used the shoulder to get space, couldn't hit. The rebound tapped out and claimed by Lincoln. So it's still a 28-point lead, 78-50 with 8:23 to go. With all those offensive rebounds, the separation on the glass is becoming very apparent, 40-24 now. And the Blue Devils have 19 offensive rebounds. As they go inside, does Lincoln, knocked loose by Tyrese Proctor out of the arms of Nix, but out of bounds, and it'll stay with Lincoln with 12 to shoot.
Yeah, you talked earlier in the game about just the size and length of this team really at every position, and kind of shows up on those rebounding stats where they have just been more than this Lincoln team could match on the glass.
Off the inbound. Garita has it deep in the right corner, sends it up top. Manitoa now. Hudson with it, drifting to the left, waits into the corner now. Nix a baseline drive and a shot clock violation. Just had no idea about the shot clock, and they turn it over for the 12th time today. And with 8 minutes to go, that's going to chase us to a timeout. 78-50, our score. The Blue Devils lead it by 28.
For any surface and every season, Continental Tire is the smart choice in tires. From ultra-high performance tires like the Extreme Contact Sport 02, the passenger touring tires, to all-terrain light truck tires like the Terrain Content AT, Continental has a tire that gives you confidence no matter the road conditions. Whether you're looking for summer, all-season, or winter tires, Continental Tire has something to fit your needs. Visit ContinentalTire.com to find your ideal tire. Continental Tire, a proud partner of the Duke Blue Devils.
Follow the Blue Devils on and off the hardwood at DukeMBB. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and more. This is Duke Basketball from Learfield.
Whether you're in the market for a new boat or just need service or accessories for an existing boat, turn to Overbee Marine. Now with two locations in Kittrell and Lake Gaston, Overbee Marine offers the highest quality of marine products and services, including the latest from Sea Ray, Centurion, Avalon, Bennington, as well as Cobalt boats. Overbee Marine also offers the largest selection of parts in the region, along with full-service facilities at their two locations. Stop by or give them a call at 252-586-3593 or online at overbeemarine.com. Overbee Marine. Don't let adventure pass you by.
This is Coke Zero Sugar. Could I be the best Coke ever? Try and taste with your ears. Hear those bubbles? Imagine that tingling on your tongue. Fizzy deliciousness. Listen to that cascading liquid. A mouth-watering waterfall. Irresistibly tasty. Zero sugar. Crisp, refreshing, and ice cold. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide.
Cameron Indoor Stadium, 8 minutes to go in the second half, and the Blue Devils lead it by 28, 78-50. Blue Devil basketball is brought to you in part by Coca-Cola. Tackle game day with the great taste of Coke Zero Sugar. Is it the best Coke ever? Try and decide. David Shumate alongside John Roth. John Rose, our producer and engineer, back inside our network studios, is Kyle Schasberger. Blue Devils with this 28-point cushion. We told you what's ahead with the schedule to come. I do want to know, we haven't talked a ton about Lincoln, obviously, because we're covering the Blue Devils side of things, and the scoreline has dictated that as well. But an interesting move to bring in Julius Hodges, their head coach, John. Obviously, a guy who's very familiar with the ACC. Did a lot of good things when he was playing at NC State.
Certainly did. Played there 20 years ago, so if you've been following ACC at least that long, you remember the name Julius Hodges was ACC Player of the Year back 20 years ago. And 2004, had a lot of games against the Blue Devils, and the Blue Devils usually prevailed those guys. He played Duke 10 times as a state player, and Duke won 8 of those, 2 times in the ACC championship game. I'm sure Julius Hodges well remembers seeing J.J. Redick light up the Wolfpack in those contests, but he did have a big moment to beat Duke when Duke was number one for one of his seasons over in Raleigh, and they knocked him off, ended an 18-game winning streak, and he had clutch free throws at the end of the game to help the Wolfpack get that win.
If his team plays like this all year long, they're going to be a handful in the CIA, as Knipple dumps one off inside for Brown, spinning, trying to maintain possession, and a foul is going to be called on the Lions, and that'll be on Nixon. That's his third. They're the preseason pick to win that league. Last year, we told you they won the tournament title. It was their first CIAA title since they were acknowledged on the official list as winner of the CIAA alongside Howard and Hampton back in 1915. As Brown is at the line to shoot a 1-1. Malik with 6 points so far. All of them came in the first half. And the front end of the 1-1 is good. Hit the bracket and tied in. By the way, they are the first, talking about Lincoln, the first degree-granting HBCU. They were established as the Ashman Institute in 1854 and renamed Lincoln University in 1866. So a lot of proud tradition for Lincoln. And now trying to add to it on the basketball front. We mentioned it's been a long drought since they'd won the CIAA, and now trying to go back-to-back. Second free throw for Brown, no good, so it's a 29-point lead, 79-50. As they lob it into the left corner, Sorber is fouled. And the foul will be on Brown, and that'll be his third. We're talking with John Shire in the pregame show. Obviously, it's been a long tradition for the Blue Devils in the preseason to play an HBCU team. A lot of times it's been the champion of the CIAA, and he talked about, obviously, aware of the platform that Duke basketball has and giving visibilities to these programs that have such rich traditions of their own. And it's been great to see Lincoln here this afternoon. They got a good workout in before the game. They're basically practicing this morning. What a good weekend for them.
It's been a long basketball day for Lincoln here at Cameron Indoor since about 10:30 this morning.
Jackson may have tweaked his right ankle. Holding on to it, they're going to stop play. One of the players for Lincoln. You don't want to see anybody get hurt in a game like this. And as we said, John, I mean, you look at the scoreline right now, the Blue Devils certainly going to be one of the best teams in the country this year. And you think about what Lincoln has in store in Division II. I mean, they are going to be a problem for people with all the different weapons they can throw out, the experience they play with. And we talk about how Hudson can make all these shots.
We are going to be keeping an eye on this team as the Division II season rolls along this year.
And Sorber has it knocked loose by Cooper Flagg at midcourt, trying to get it back, could not. It's into the hands of Caleb Foster. There's Brown, the lob! And Flagg will throw it down!
Great lob from Brown, and Cooper Flagg just took it with one hand and ripped that rim down.
And we've got another stoppage and perhaps another turned ankle as Cleveland is hobbling to the bench. For Lincoln. My goodness. Cooper Flagg soaring in. I think something we're going to see a lot this year. The two-handed flex for the youngster as well. So, what else is in that deep bag of tricks for Cooper Flagg? We've seen the blocks. We've seen the threes. We've seen the punches.
We've
seen the assists.
Wow.
And there's another deflection by Malik Brown that chases Sorber into backcourt. Brown, of course, a member of the ACC All-Defensive Team a year ago when he was at Syracuse, led the ACC with 71 steals. 81-50 our scores. We're under 7 minutes to go. He knocks it loose again, and this time Sion James trying to get it. Brown with the deflection, but Sion's going to pick up the foul, and that'll be his fourth. Just the fourth on the Blue Devils. And Malik finished last year at Syracuse with three consecutive double-doubles, had 11 and 12 against NC State in the ACC tournament for the Orange. Of course, had a massive game here at Cameron Indoor Stadium.
26, 11 out of 16 shooting. Yeah, he knows what it's like to play here.
Right now he's got 7 points, three rebounds, two assists. As we see Isaiah Evans come to check in at the next dead ball. Hudson has it. Crossing over at the top of the key. A bounce pass inside. Trying to find some space. Fading away and rattling out. On the jump shot is Jameer Brewer. And here comes Proctor the other way. Right to left. A cross court hit for Harris. Thought about a three. He will launch. And it wouldn't go. And the rebound into the hands of Manny Toa. The threes not falling with quite the clip they were in the first half. The Blue Devils 1 out of 10 from distance here in the second, but they still made 10 today. Another theft by Brown on a cross-court feed. Here's Proctor back for Harris, and he'll throw it down with two hands.
Very good awareness by Proctor. Just kind of looked over his left shoulder and knew that Harris would be following the play and calmly dished it to him for the finish.
That's the ninth steal of the afternoon for this Blue Devil defense. And it's turned into a dunk drill. Forget the layup line. As Hudson looks inside, tries the lob, deflected by Proctor. And who touched it last? They say the Blue Devils did. It looked like maybe it caught a finger of Coach Sanus, but the officials disagree. Evans in, Proctor out with 5:49 to go. You wonder, for some of these guys, can Nipple flag Tyrese and maybe Mamalawatch if that's the end of the day with 5:49 to go and a 33-point lead? As Coach Sanus leaves it on the left for Hudson. Off of a screen set up top by Brewer. Into the paint, floats at the end of the shot clock. It wouldn't go, and the rebound for Evans. Strong to Clayman. And here comes Sion James the other way, right to left. 5.5 minutes to go. For the trailer, Evans and now Brown. Into the corner, it's Harris. Back up top, Isaiah Evans. A ball fake and a three. Short. And the rebound kicked out for Hudson and Lincoln. 3-on-3 in transition. He gets it inside, and the layup is good for Manny Toa. His first points of the second half make it 83-52. Well, the Blue Devils not slowing down, though, quickly across midcourt as we approach 5 minutes to play. That bucket for Lincoln snapped a 6-0 run over the last 4 minutes and change. As Caleb Foster goes to work on the right baseline, 4 feet out, put the shoulder into him to get some space, hit it, and he's headed to the free throw line as Elijah Nix picked up number 4. The physicality of Caleb Foster creating space, he's got 7, and now free throw coming as well.
And he's also played today without committing a turnover so far amongst his ball handling responsibilities.
You know, the Blue Devils are just 8 turnovers, just 2 since the break. Now Caleb trying to make it 86-52. And he does. And with 4:56 to go, only a little bit of mystery left in this one. How deep into the bench does John Shire go this afternoon? And maybe when, if not if, do the Blue Devils cross the century mark? As here's another steal by Evans in transition, 3-on-2. To the right, there's Harris, and he hits a three. I think it might be when they cross the century mark with 4:37 to go, up 89-52. Nix has it now for Lincoln. Behind the back with a dribble, waiting, bounces it to the baseline, nearly lost by Brewer. Eastlands went inside for Coach Sanus, who can't hit the turnaround. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Manny Toa. Nope, they're going to say Harris touched it last. And a fresh 20 for Lincoln. As Julius Hodge is getting just about everybody in his rotation involved as well. The only one we haven't seen is Tyleek Fields and Marshall Roberson, those two. As they look to inbound, and a bounce pass for Coach Sanus, knocked loose by James, and last touch by Lincoln on the way out of bounds. You know, nothing easy.
Yeah, solid defense on the out-of-bounds underplay. Certainly Coach John Shire is going to want to see a lot of that this year.
It'll be Caleb Foster to bring it across. leading by 37. James is open on the left, and he rains one down from outside. Zion James with seven, and the lead is 40, 92 to 52. Their 12th three of the day. And Lincoln's going to use their last timeout. That'll chase us to a timeout as well. 3:56 to go. Duke rolling in their first exhibition game, up by 40, 92 to 52.
Progressive presents Renters MVP's Most Valuable Possessions. Today's MVP, Emily Neal's 70-inch TV. Because after watching her second-grade students yell at each other for hours, there's nothing Emily enjoys more than watching super-rich housewives also yell at each other. Why? Because those women are not her responsibility. And that's why her TV is today's MVP. Keep your most valuable possessions protected by bundling your renters and auto insurance with Progressive. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers not available in all states.
It's time to review the top three highlights of the day. I'm joined, as always, by my co-anchor, Snoop.
Hey, what up, Joe?
Snoop, number one has to be getting the new iPhone 16 Pro with Apple Intelligence at T-Mobile.
Yeah, you should hustle down to T-Mobile like a dog chasing a squirrel chasing a nut.
Nice analogy, Snoop. Dogs do love to chase squirrels.
And squirrels love to chase those nuts.
On to highlight number two, at T-Mobile, families can save 20% every month versus the other big guys.
That is very impressive. You know, y'all can take some of those savings and buy some Snoop merchandise.
That's exactly what I'm planning on doing with my savings, Snoop. Now, take it away, Snoop.
Head to T-Mobile.com and get the new iPhone 16 Pro with Apple Intelligence. On them. Now drop that jingle.
For 24-month bill credits, eligible trade-in on Go5G Next. Well-qualified customers plus tax and $35 connection charge. Cancel entire account before receiving 24 bill credits and credits. Stop and balance on required finance agreement due. Bill credits end if you pay off device early. See how you can save versus the other big guys at T-Mobile.com/switch. Apple Intelligence coming fall 2024.
Cooper had been out since the 15:02 mark with those two fouls. As they lob it in for Sorber, deflected, stolen. Gill has got a piece, and now a run out for Brown to throw it down.
Third dunk of the game so far for Brown. Puts the Blue Devils back up by five.
24-19 as we approach the midway point of the opening half.
And that's one of 10 steals on the afternoon for the Duke Blue Devils. Mason Gill has taken one away, and that set up Malik Brown for a jam in the first half. Our defensive play of the game presented by Old Dominion Freight Line. Old Dominion Freight Line works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to be the official freight carrier of Duke Athletics. Kyle Schatzberger with you, John Roth and John Rose, and the voice of the Blue Devils now with Duke leading 92-52, 3:57 to play in the second half. David Shoemaker.
All right, Kyle, thank you. You mentioned those 10 takeaways. Points off of turnovers, really lopsided now, 31-5, favoring the Blue Devils. And, of course, there'll be a lot to talk about with the head coach after the game is over with. Blue Devils have outscored Lincoln 15-2 over the last 6 minutes or so, a 9-0 run at the moment. But, John, you look up. Lincoln only has 18 points since halftime. They're 8 of 21 from the field in the second half, 2 of 7 from 3, and they have not gotten to the free throw line at all after getting there 9 times in the first half. I imagine the head coach is going to be pleased with the defense in the second half.
You would think those are some good numbers, and obviously particularly the foul aspect of being able to get all that done without putting them on the free throw line at all is one of the more positive aspects, even with Hudson knocking down a few shots and hitting 24 points. It's been a really good defensive effort here over the whole game, but particularly the second half.
Out of the timeout, James, Isaiah Evans, Darren Harris, Malik Brown, and we see Cameron Sheffield for the first time, the grad transfer from Rice. Alfred, a Georgia native, as they go inside, spinning is Brewer. Can't hit. The rebound for Sion James. You hear a roar from the crazies. That's because Spencer Hubbard just came to the scorer's table to check in at the next dead ball, as will Neil Begovich. As Evans sends it up top for Brown. To the left, there's Harris. Darren in front of his own bench to James now. Now Brown has it. A touch pass outside, and Evans hits a three on the right. Isaiah Evans with his first field goal. He's got four, and it's 95-52. And now it's a 12-0 push over the last 90 seconds or so.
You know, seven different guys have hit a three for the Blue Devils in this game so far.
13 in total. Five for Knipple. Crazy. Up top, Brewer. Now a three from the top of the key as well off the mark out of the hands of Young. And James has the rebound. 2:47 to go. Malik has it on the left into the corner. Harris, now Evans again. Hit one on the right. And now he's got one on the left. Back-to-back threes. 98-52. And John Shire is going to use a timeout to get some subs in as we see Spencer Hubbard come in for the first time. The Los Angeles native and Neil Begovich out of San Francisco, California. Sheffield, Evans, and Harris will stay. And there you hear the roar for number 55. Wouldn't it be something if he hit the bucket to take him over 100 on the day? Final 2.5 minutes from Cameron. 98-52. They lob it inside. Kostin Juice able to lay it in, and he's fouled. So he'll have a chance at a three-point play with 8 points now. Only one in double figures for Lincoln this afternoon. Hudson, he had 24 on 11 of 22 shooting. No one else has more than 8 to this point. And that's Kostin Juice, who just scored, trying to get to 9 with the second. Meanwhile, the Blue Devils have 3 in double figures. Flagg with 22, Proctor with 19, and Knippel with 17 as the free throw is good. 98-55 as Spencer Hubbard brings it across. Begovich now around to the left. There's Harris. Curling into the paint, kicks to the right. Sheffield a 3. Too strong. The rebound into the hands of Young. Long hit ahead, hit the referee, stayed in bounds. Begovich has it. A theft for the Blue Devils. 4-on-2. Harris to take it over 100, and he does on the left. Harris hits the 3, and it's 101-55. We've seen that work out for either team today where a ball hit an official that was in play and it turned into a turnover. As trying to hit a cutter inside was Nix, but he turned it over. And it's Spencer Hubbard one-on-one, put it off the window, count it, and a foul. And the bench is losing their mind.
Hubbard in the open floor the last two possessions. First time he dribbled down, sped there, and got the assist on Harris's 3. And this time he takes it all the way himself, works around a defender, and gets the drive to drop.
Young is fouled out. That's his 5th. And now Spencer to the charity stripe. Trying to make it 104-55 as Stanley Borden will come into the game now. The senior out of Istanbul, Turkey, and Sheffield will leave. So it's Borden, Begovich, Hubbard, Harris, and Evans right now. And the free throw came out, rebound tapped out. Lincoln has it. They've emptied their bench a little bit as well. We see Marshall Roberson out there for the first time, as is Tyleek Fields. Up top, Brewer into the paint, spins on Begovich, goes up, missed the layup, and the rebound for Evans. 90 seconds to go. By the way, this is a 20-3 spurt over the last 3 minutes for John Shire's group. Evans for Hubbard. 103-55. Crossing over, top of the key, thinking about it, gets the screen, tried to feed the corner, deflected, came back to him. Back to Begovich on the right. Up top, Hubbard, 9 to shoot. Thinking about it, a jab step and a 3. Didn't get the roll. The rebound for Begovich. What a rebound inside. Tapped it out to Evans. He'll drive, feed it to Borden. Scoop it up and in. Stanley Borden gets a bucket. And the lead is 50, 105-55. Into the final minute now. Driving the right, Brewer spinning in traffic. Fades away from 15, can't hit. Weak side rebound, Borden. One final opportunity at a bucket, barring an offensive rebound with 38 seconds to go. Spencer feeds it to the left. Evans thought about a 3. He'll drive instead into the paint, step through, and score again. Isaiah Evans. Now with 9, and it's a 52-point lead with 20 seconds to go. As the Our House chant breaks out of Cameron Indoor Stadium, as the ball is deflected into backcourt and will go out of bounds. It'll stay with Lincoln with 12.7 to go. 9 straight. What a strong finish, even with some of the backups on the floor and some of the walk-ons for head coach John Shire. 24-3 over the last 4.5 minutes. Final 7 seconds now. Lincoln on the drive, going to get a foul called on the drive. He's going inside was Brewer. And we'll have free throws with 4.8 to go. Blue Devils, as we said, with three in double figures. Cooper Flagg was spectacular with 22 this afternoon. 19 for Tyrese Proctor, 17 for Con Knipple. They're led in rebounding by Kaman Maluach. He had 11. Also had 4 points as the first free throw was good. Makes it 107-56. Just waiting on the final score now. As the second free throw wouldn't go. A 51-point lead. 2 seconds to go. Begovic will dribble it out. And the Blue Devils take care of business here in their first exhibition game. Dominating Lincoln 107-56. A staggering defensive effort in the second half, only giving up 22 points, and the offense was good throughout as they made 15 threes, out-rebounded the Lions 48-30, and won it going away. 107-56, the final score. We'll take a break. Have more from Cameron in just a moment.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Duke Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
This is Coke Zero Sugar. Could I be the best Coke ever? Try and taste with your ears. Hear those bubbles? Imagine them tingling on your tongue. Fizzy deliciousness. Listen to that cascading liquid. A mouth-watering waterfall. Irresistibly tasty. Zero sugar. Crisp. Refreshing. And ice cold. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide.
Duke plays here.
Flying in, reverses it. Up and in for two.
This is the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield.
You can always say good morning, but when you're about to enjoy McDonald's breakfast, you say good morning.
Now, get two sausage burritos, hash browns, and a medium hot coffee for just $5 and participate in McDonald's.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Rust. Right now, save $20 on the BGA 57 battery blower set, including the AK-20 battery and AL-101 battery charger. Real steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. Available for a limited time at participating dealers while supplies last.
Which schools will take home the prestigious Learfield Director's Cup as the top college athletic programs for the 2024-25 college athletics season? You can follow the standings of your favorite team or alma mater at L Director's Cup on Twitter and online at TheDirectorsCup.com. Trophies will be awarded in June 2025 to the winning institutions in all college sports divisions. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics.
On the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield, welcome to the Duke Locker Room Report. Our exclusive coverage of today's game has been brought to you by Coca-Cola. Crisp, refreshing, and irresistibly tasty. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide. Reed's Jewelers, your home for fine Swiss timepieces, beautiful diamonds, and the world's most luxurious jewelry brands. Reed's Jewelers, trusted with life's moments. By Continental Tire, the exclusive tire of the Blue Devils. Find the right tire for your vehicle at ContinentalTire.com. Continental Tire, the smart choice in tires. By the Hilton Garden Inn, your home base near Duke University. By Duke Health, be a game changer. The Duke team is pioneering the future of healthcare for communities in the Triangle and beyond. Discover what's possible at careers.dukehealth.org. And by the Washington Duke Inn, honoring tradition over trend for over 30 years. Now, inside the Learfield Network studios, here's Kyle Schassberger.
107-56, the final tally from Cameron Indoor Stadium. Blue Devils take the first of two exhibitions here ahead of the start. November 4th against Maine, the beginning of the regular season on the hardwood for the Duke Blue Devils. 107-56, again, the final count behind. Three in double figures here against Lincoln University out of Pennsylvania. Cooper Flagg, 22 points, 8 of 16 from the floor. Con Knipple at 17 on 6 of 11. And Tyrese Proctor came off the bench, 19, 5 of 7. We'll pour through all those numbers coming up in the postgame show. Give you some electrifying plays as well from a couple of freshmen in Knipple and, of course, Flagg and others. Highlight, scoring, recap, scoreboard update as well. Week 8 in college football. We'll go over all of that. Look ahead to Arizona State and the next exhibition coming up a week from tomorrow at 7 o'clock start. Between the Sun Devils and the Blue Devils, away from that coach John Shire as well. 107-56 is the final. Let's go back inside Cameron Indoor Stadium now and rejoin the voice of the Blue Devils, David Chume. And David, Duke wasted no time. It was maybe nip and tuck early on, but the Blue Devils asserted their strength and their power and ran away with some huge runs throughout this one.
Yeah, just dominated, really, once you got to the midway point of the first half, I would say, and the Blue Devils just pulled away methodically, leading by as many as 52 in this game. They won it by 51, 107-56, and it was everything you thought it would be from this talented freshman class, with Cooper Flagg going for 22. Con Knipple had 17 on the strength of 5 3-pointers, and then the experience of Tyrese Proctor. He came off the bench today, had 19, 5 of 7 shooting, hit a couple of threes, and 7 of 8 at the line. I'm sure the head coach is going to love the assist total, 25 all told, led by Flagg, who had 6. But look, all these guys with 3. Brown had 3. Knipple had 3. James had 3. Proctor had 3. And 2 apiece for Harris and Evans as they got some run as well. 12 steals for the Blue Devils. We talked earlier about points off of turnovers. That ended up being 36-5, the advantage. They dominated the glass 47-21. Had 19 offensive rebounds, leading to 19 second chance points. Outscored Lincoln on the break 19-5, and the bench scoring 46-14 was the advantage. It was a game that they never trailed, and in the end they won it by 51. As we're looking over our postgame stats presented by Steel, pro level performance at work and at home right now. Save $50 on the BGA 57 battery blower. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. We told you about the guys in double figures. Give you the rest of the scores for John Shire's group today. Isaiah Evans had 9 off the bench, 3 of 5 shooting with 2 threes. We mentioned the 2 assists. Also had a steal. 8 points apiece for Caleb Foster. He was 3 of 8 from the field, had an assist and a steal as well. 8 points on the afternoon for Darren Harris, 3 of 5 from the field. He had 2 threes and 2 assists. 7 points apiece for Malik Brown and Sion James in this one as they combined to shoot 6 of 8 from the field. James hit a 3, and Brown stacked on 4 rebounds, 3 assists, and 3 steals. Just a lot to like, no matter where you looked on the stat sheet, as the Blue Devils won it by 51, 107-56. But for now, it's time to head down to the Duke locker room for our postgame interview with head coach John Shire. It's brought to you by Continental Tire, the exclusive tire of the Blue Devils. Find the right tire for your vehicle at ContinentalTire.com. Continental Tire, the smart choice in tires. And here's John Roth.
Thanks a lot, David. And first time you get to play another team in this preseason with this team. What are some of the things that you like most about what you saw over the last 40 minutes?
Well, I liked how we grew into the game. You know, I thought we got, you know, just again, it's so new. Just for us to get the experience of what it's like to play in Cameron, to play against an athletic team. I mean, Lincoln, they have their entire team back. So I thought they were really well prepared, together, quick. And our defense has got a long way to go. But overall, I thought we had some really good spurts of how we can have the potential to play.
What are some of the things you liked when you saw some of those spurts that make you feel good about what you're building?
Well, some of the connecting plays, you know, 25 assists and 8 turnovers. You know, I like that. I like hitting open people. I like driving and playing off of 2 feet in the paint, you know, under control. I like guarding the ball. I like when we rebounded with 5 guys versus when we didn't. But again, it's all about building habits. And our habits, you know, it's impossible to be there on day one today. But this is a great viewing for us just to show and see what we need to get a lot better at. So I can tell you as a staff, we definitely have that.
One of the things do you do with an opportunity to play an exhibition game like this kind of early is just kind of look in the combinations for you as well, of players that play Absolutely. Together, what works together?
Absolutely. I mean, look, we started a group. We may not start the next game. We play different minutes, different combinations. And, you know, I learned a lot from today. You know, I think, guys, you know, we have we don't have a team where it's, you know, John, we don't have a team where it's like you have a point guard and the backup point guard and the shooting guard and the backup shooting guard. You have a bunch of positionless guys, and so you're the competition from within to earn playing time is kind of against everybody, but also allows you to go big, go small, have shooting, defending, whatever it is. And I thought tonight, you know, you had a chance to look at Kaman and Malik in together. Had a chance to go smaller, just different lineups. I felt that was important for us.
Obviously, it's early, and we could ask you about a lot of different guys, and we'll probably do that over the next few weeks as you play games. But, you know, two of your freshmen really had particularly standout performances, Cooper, obviously, and Edcon Knipple as well. Just talk a little bit about their games and showing a lot of different things that they can do, from the threes to driving in and throwing down one-handed dunks.
Yeah, I mean, look, there was a heck of a play by Khan on that dunk, and Cooper and Khan, they have high motor. They're not afraid. They're smart. They're tough. You know, I thought they had, you know, for being freshmen to have this, you know, as their initial game, I thought was pretty good. And we'll have to watch the film back. But those guys, man, are warriors, are tough. I'm proud of what they did.
And I would think you would have liked the aggressiveness of Tyrese when he came off the bench and ended up with a lot of points, but a lot of really aggressive moves on the offensive end.
Tyrese just came in, was aggressive, you know, showed he played like a vet. Thought his defense was really good. I was really pleased with what Tyrese did.
And then you've got another week before you play a second exhibition game, so only a lot of anticipation for that one, given the charity exhibition, the opponent, Bobby Hurley coming back, a lot of things looking ahead to next weekend. But what are some of the things you want to do with your team as you get ready to take on another team before the regular season starts?
Well, we need to see over the next week of practice, we have to make another big jump, just everything. I mean, I could go, I'm not going to bore you, you know, with every area I feel we can get better at, but it's going to be, I don't know much yet. I mean, I have to study them, but I do know they have a lot of I do know they have a lot of talent. Obviously, Bobby is a coach. His teams are always going to be hard-nosed and tough. And, you know, that game is, you know, going to be a great thing for us just to get another gauge for where we're at. And then we have another week to build after that.
Well, you're not going to bore me, but fun time here today for a lot of the fans. And we're looking forward to seeing how you progress with this team as time goes on here early in the year.
Thanks so much, John.
All right, David, back to you.
And a win in the exhibition opener, 107-56. They take care of business against Lincoln. We were taking you through our postgame stats presented by Steele. Do want to give you the rest of the scores. We left off with Brown and James, who each had 7 points here this afternoon. 4 points on the day for Malu Watch. He also was the leading rebounder with the 11, hitting one of his four shots from the field. Also had an assist to Steele and two block shots. 2 points on the afternoon for Mason Gillis. Hubbard also got a bucket late with the and-one opportunity. He finished the day with two. Stanley Borden also scored as he had two. Sheffield and Begovic both played a little more than 2 minutes, did not score. The leading man in terms of block shots was Cooper Flagg. He had four. The leading steal man was Malik Brown. He had 3 of the 12. And as we told you, Flagg was the lead assist man. He had 6 of the 25 as the Blue Devils win it 107-56. We'll take a break. Have more from Cameron in just a moment.
Texting while driving takes your eyes off the road for an average of 5 seconds. That's like driving the length of a basketball court 3 times with your eyes closed. Research shows that you are 3 times more likely to get into an accident when distracted by a cell phone while driving. I'm joining Trusted Choice Independent Insurance Agents to urge you and your families to put down your phone. Let's have a hands-free NC. Brought to you by Trusted Choice Independent Insurance Agents of North Carolina. Learn more at trustedchoice.com/goduke.
Let me grab my car keys and we'll roll.
We still going to that new bar downtown?
Yeah, supposed to be fun. Lexi, give me driving directions from home to downtown bar district.
Autocorrect. Suggest Uber. Pick up. Home. Drop off downtown bar district.
No, I'm driving.
Suggest the Metro bus. Departing in 12 minutes.
Point taken, Lexi. We'll grab a ride.
If you drink, don't drive. Decide to ride. Brought to you in partnership by Anheuser-Busch, Mothers Against Drunk Driving, and Uber.
Duke plays here.
Flying in, reverses it, up and in for two.
This is the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
Receive double patty to make nuggets so crisp, and the fries go to yellow, yeah, McDonald's don't miss. $5, that's a deal, yeah.
I got McDonald's money, I got McDonald's money.
Prove it with our 96% referral rate and courteous background check movers. We're local and affordable. We can help at a price that won't make you wish you'd done it on your own. When you're ready, give us a call or find us online for a free estimate at twomenandatruck.com.
I feel happy, Valero Pay Plus app.
I feel happy, it makes savings a snap.
Use it and start saving automatically.
You just save some money, non-shabby.
I feel happy, I'm in and out real fast.
I feel happy, now pit stops are a blast.
Download today and get in on the fun. Valero Pay Plus app, your savings have begun.
Back inside Cameron Indoor Stadium, 107-56. The final scores. The Blue Devils take the exhibition opener over Lincoln. In this game, they were 18-26 from the free throw line. And Food Line is the proud sponsor of the Score to Get More program. Last year alone, a total of 30,000 meals were donated to help our neighbors in need. Well, one of the stars today for the Blue Devils got a start. Zion James had 7 points, 3 assists, and 2 steals. He's standing by with John Roth.
Thanks a lot, David, and appreciate you joining us, Sion. And let's just talk for a second just about the overall place of a game like this and you guys developing your team for the season. First time you've got to play against another squad in front of an audience and all of that. Like, how important was it just to get out there on the floor and get a feel for this team in front of a crowd?
It was important. We needed it. We definitely needed to figure each other out. We got used to beating up on each other for, I think Coach said, 62 practices since we all got here. So it was more than time to play somebody else. We definitely needed to settle in. We showed that early. It was pretty ugly earlier and throughout, especially defensively. But we showed that once we figured it out, especially in the second half, that there's a lot of good things that we can do.
Yeah, what are maybe some of the things that impressed you about the performance once you guys got going, as you say, after the first few moments and started to build and build throughout the game?
Well, offensively, it's cool how easily we can score once the ball moves. They were really heavy in the gaps, and we're a team that can make simple plays and win games very simply. And when we did that, we scored very easily. And then defensively, when we just did the things that we were taught to do. Early on, they were scoring because we weren't keeping the ball in front. We weren't getting to our defensive coverage as well. But once we started doing that, they started coughing the ball up, and we started getting better and better looks.
Overall, obviously, this is a Duke team that's got, I think, maybe, 10 new players from last year, and all from different places, recruiting and different schools, like you coming in from Tulane, and kind of getting all that together, getting on, kind of on the same page as the season gets started. How do you feel that process has been going as you guys have tried to connect with each other?
It's been going really good. We've figured each other out a lot, but like I said, there's only so much figuring each other out you can do when you're beating up on each other all the time. So this is the first time we're all 15 guys we had are playing towards the same goal. So it's a different kind of figuring each other out now. Now we know a lot about each other's skills and what we bring to the table, just from, like I said, our 62 practices. But now we can work on learning how to win with a 15-person team.
You've obviously played a lot of college basketball from your previous institution, and you bring a lot of experience and some veteran presence and some toughness to the Duke program with your arrival here. Just tell us a little bit about how you hope to contribute and the kind of difference you hope to make within the group here.
And just try to keep everyone together and highlight what everyone's good at. Obviously, we've got incredible guys, Coop and Khan, and I think Tyrese. Those guys were on one today. And today was their day, but we've got a lot of guys that can be their day, myself included. But my focus is on making sure when it's Coop's day that we keep feeding them. When it's Khan's day that we keep feeding them, that I keep highlighting what everyone does well. That's the thing that I think is really my role in the team, what I can do best.
And just lastly, what do you think is some of the defensive potential of this team? Obviously, it takes time to build into all the things you were mentioning a moment ago with the rotations, everybody learning each other. But what kind of potential do you see defensively for this group? I know you want it to be part of the main identity of the team.
Potential is through the roof. We can do anything defensively. We've got height. We've got length. We've got two different big guys, and we get big guys who can do different things for us in terms of defensive coverages. There's really anything we can do. The world is ours defensively once we really fully buy in on the end of the floor and then sharpen up things that we're good at.
Well, really appreciate you taking out some time in your day. Congrats on getting this season going with an exhibition win. Look forward to a lot more down the road. Appreciate your time, though. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, of course. Thank you.
All right, that's Sion James down in the locker room, guys.
All right, John, thank you. What an impressive and mature young man. We've already talked about some of the charity work he does in the community, and you hear him talking about getting other guys involved, knowing it was their day. When it's their day, you feed them. Just wise beyond his years, and we talk about all the starts that he's made in his career at Tulane, 107, and he starts today in the exhibition opener and a part of a 51-point win for the Blue Devils, 107-56. Give you kind of the final numbers in terms of the stats. We talk about the individual numbers, but when you look at the shooting overall, they were 52% from the field, 40.5%, I should say, from three, 15 of 37, and hit their free throws as well, 18 of 26, while holding Lincoln.
With all these new winners at the North Carolina Education Lottery Winners Club, we need to decide who's in charge.
We need a top prize winner.
We need someone who's good with words, like us crossword winners.
If elected leader, I will extend the hours during which all winners can use the diamond-encrusted hot tub.
Yes! New scratch-offs mean new winners. This month's tickets are packed with $370 million in total prizes. The Winners Club awaits. Must be 18 to play. Approximate overall odds of winning range from 1 in 3.04 to 4.31. Problem gambling helpline 877-718-5543.
Blue Devil fans, here's your chance to team up with Duke Basketball in a season-long effort to support Duke Children's Hospital. We're asking 1,000 fans to be hoops heroes for the kids at Duke Children's by making a $25 gift to the Charity Stripe 1,000 Challenge. Your gift enters you for a chance to win tickets to the Duke-UNC game in Cameron Indoor Stadium on February 1st. Give your $25 by texting Hoops Hero to 919-372-4159 and become a Duke Children's Hoops Hero today.
You're listening to Duke Basketball on the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
Morning people wake up for peace and quiet. McDonald's breakfast people, we wake up for the sweet rush of getting that warm, delicious breakfast right before it ends.
Now, for only $5, get two sausage burritos, hash browns, and a small hot coffee. Order ahead on the app, and your $5 breakfast is ready when you get here. Price of participation may vary. Single item at regular price. Limited time offer. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Enjoying the game but not the drink being spilled down your back or the foam finger poking you in the face? Well, head to the concession stand, grab a Lindy's Italian Ice, and take a 6-ounce vacation. A 6-ounce cup of lemon Italian ice will make you feel like you're swaying in a hammock and the only thing in your face is a cool, salty breeze. That ought to have you refreshed. Now get your head back in the game and start belting out Blue and White with the youthful exuberance of the freshman behind you. Yes, the same one that keeps spilling his drink down your back. Lindy's Italian Ice. Have an ice day.
24 Wolverines, TV TV, CV, and Spell. Final score from Cameron Indoor Stadium, 107-56. The Blue Devils knock off the Lions of Lincoln University in the first of two exhibition games. November 4th will be the regular season opener, 7 o'clock tip from Cameron against Maine. Kyle Shasberg with you inside our network studios. Had a brief droppage out at Cameron. We'll see if we can reconnect back out to David Shumate and John Ross. But you've heard from Sion James, and then before that, John Shire, following this win over the Lions of Lincoln University. Again, 107-56, three in double figures, 22 for Cooper Flagg, 17 for Con Knipple, 19 for Tyrese Proctor, 15 of those coming in the first half, same for Knipple, and Flagg with his 22. He paced everyone in scoring for the Blue Devils. Leading scorer for the Lions was Hudson with 24. As we continue to pour through some of the stats brought to you by Steel, it's time for a look at our in-game stats brought to you by Steel. Create a backyard that's out of this world. Right now, save $50 on the MS-250 gas chainsaw. Real Steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com. I can hear them in my right ear, so if they want to motion at any point, I can go back to camera. But 107-56 again is the final. John Shire talked about protecting the basketball, the connection plays, the turnovers. Just 8 turnovers for the Blue Devils, and they had assisted in this contest 25 times on 37 made baskets. Again, 52% from the floor, 41% from downtown, and 15 of 37 at the free throw line. David Shumate is back with us now. I'm going to go back to the Crow's Nest, high atop Coach K Court at Cambridge Indoor Stadium again following this 107-56 win over Lincoln. David?
We're 12 days from Halloween. We're not supposed to get the spooky stuff here in the fall. We got a couple of weeks. Sorry about the technical difficulties as we were starting to wrap things up here at Cameron Indoor Stadium. But it was a fun afternoon as the Blue Devils won it by 51, 107-56. Looking ahead, the Blue Devils will be back at home against Arizona State a week from tomorrow night as they take on the Sun Devils at 7 o'clock. And we'll have pregame coverage for the Brotherhood Run. A wonderful night. A lot of charity fundraising going to go on to benefit the Duke Children's Hospital. Also, the return of Bobby Hurley. You heard the guys talking about that in the postgame conversation with head coach John Shire. Really looking forward to next Sunday night. And then beyond that, we look ahead to the regular season opener with Maine coming up on November 4th at 7 o'clock. But for now, that's going to do it from here in Cameron. Again, apologies for the technical stuff. Hopefully, we get the gremlins out of the board as we head towards the regular season. But for now, let's send it back to the studio where Kyle's going to take you through the ACC scoreboard, and he was taking you through some of the stats as well. He'll take you through some of the big moments. But for John Roth and John Rose here at Cameron, I'm David Shumate. Thanks so much for listening. Hope you guys have a great rest of the weekend. Kyle, back to you. Enjoy Halloween. It's coming up, my man.
Yeah, thank you so much. Can't wait to hear what kind of goodies y'all will have in the booth ahead of SMU coming up for football next weekend. Always fun with Dave Harding, John Roth, and David Shumate. Called a football victory. John Rose, of course, engineering 23-16 was the final in football last night. Blue Devils bowl eligible in 7 games or 6-1. And then they followed that up with the exhibition win over Lincoln University, 107-56. So joyous couple of days here for the Blue Devils. And be one more exhibition tune-up coming up against Sun Devils, as David had pointed out. That's a week from tomorrow against Arizona State, a 7 o'clock tip-off. 6 o'clock will be the network coverage. Let's take you through the out-of-town scoreboard quickly, and then we'll hit some of those key plays in our final segment here as we wrap up this first exhibition tune-up on the season. Games in progress in the ACC. 6th-ranked Miami and Louisville. You talk about offensive fireworks. This one has gone back and forth. The Hurricanes are trying to create some separation between them and the Cards in the final 3 minutes of the ball game. And it appeared Cam Ward had endured a strip sack fumble that Louisville had taken to the house that would have tied this game up at 45. But after video review, call was reversed, favoring the Hurricanes. They maintained possession, were able to punch it in again. They lead 52-38 over the Cardinals. Louisville with the ball, have it at their own 29. Now they're 40, facing a 4th and 8. Down 2 scores, 2 touchdowns, 52-38 with 2:44 remaining in the fourth quarter. Just underway at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, 12th-ranked Notre Dame and Georgia Tech. Scoreless, they have just kicked things off in that contest. A couple of finals to report. Wake Forest downs UConn on the road, 23-20. 10th-ranked Clemson moves to 6-1, 48-31 over Virginia. Still to come tonight, NC State and Cal. That's actually in a few moments as well from Berkeley's. Wolfpack will kick things off with Golden Bears and what will be a 12:30 local time kick in the state of California. 21st-ranked SMU and Stanford will tangle on the farm. That one coming up much later, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock local time. Virginia Tech also a winner on Thursday, 42-21. Of the top 25 early window games, so many are anticipating the showdown in Austin between Texas and Georgia. That will kick at 7:30. Tennessee and Alabama are moments away from kicking, but among the earlier results to note, Kurt Cignetti and the Indiana Hoosiers, 16th-ranked IU, blasts off on Nebraska at home, 56-7. Army, 23rd-ranked Black Knights, remain undefeated, 7-0 now, 6-0 in the American after a 45-28 win over East Carolina. And still coming down the final stretch, under a minute to play in Como, 19th-ranked Missouri, 21, Auburn, 17. And 25th-ranked Navy in Charlotte, just underway, no score in Annapolis. Again, our final score, 107-56. We'll take a timeout, and we'll give you some of the key plays before we put a bow on this one. Look ahead to Sunday against Arizona State. It's after this on the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
Are you ready to show your Duke pride wherever you go? Visit shop.duke.edu, your one-stop online store for all things Duke. From the latest apparel to must-have accessories, Duke University Stores has it all. Whether you're a student, alumni, or fan, shop.duke.edu has something for everyone. Get your hands on exclusive Duke gear today. Shop conveniently online at shop.duke.edu, where real Duke fans shop.
Hey, Duke fans, want to enhance your game day experience? Poetry Finance, official digital banking partner of Duke Athletics, is here to help. With Poetry, managing your finances is a breeze. Just download the Poetry app to discover how Poetry Finance can help you. Poetry Finance, write your own future. Start now. Financial tools for everyone. Let us help you get started at poetryfinance.com. That's poetryfinance.com.
A 60-second local break timeout. Then more Duke basketball. You're listening to the Blue Devil Sports Network from Learfield.
Whether you're in the market for a new boat or just need service or accessories for an existing boat, turn to Overby Marine. Now with two locations in Kittrell and Lake Gaston, Overby Marine offers the highest quality of marine products and services, including the latest from Sea Ray, Centurion, Avalon, Bennington, as well as Cobalt boats. Overby Marine also offers the largest selection of parts in the region, along with full-service facilities at their two locations. Stop by or give them a call at 252-586-3593 or online at overbymarine.com. Overby Marine. Don't let adventure pass you by.
Hey, y'all, this is Michael Felder, co-host of College Sports Now. We're breaking down all the action from around the country every week during the football season. We'll look beyond the box score and keep our finger on the pulse of college football from September all the way through the national championship game in January. Listen all season long on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you love to get your favorite podcast. And be sure to follow along on Twitter at CSNowTweets.
Beats Lincoln University by 51, 107-56, the exhibition final inside Cameron Indoor Stadium. Kyle Schatzberg with you again inside Studio 21 after this 107-56 victory, three in double figures. Cooper Flagg with 22, Tyrese Proctor with 19, and Con Knipple each with 17 points. Blue Devils shot 52% from the floor, 41% from three. Out-rebounded the Lions by 16. Nine more coming on the offensive window, plus seven on the defensive glass, plus 12 in second chance points. The bench for Duke outscored Lincoln University 46-14, plus 18 advantage in the paint on the break. It was a plus 14 edge, 6-2 in blocks, favoring the Blue Devils, 12-4 in steals, 25-8 on assists. Those 25 assists on 37 made baskets, 37-71 overall, and 15 of 37 from downtown. Take you through a few of the key plays, some of the highlight reel efforts from the Blue Devils. 10 new faces on this squad. Tyrese Proctor, Caleb Foster, the most notable returnees to this year's team that fell in the Elite Eight to NC State a year ago. 24-25. Regular season will begin on Monday, November 4th against Maine. It'll be Foster and Proctor that will be two of the key catalysts in helping to move this thing forward as the Blue Devils look to return to the Final Four, the ACC favorites picked by the coaches in the preseason just a week ago. But the newcomers as well, Con Knipple, one of those guys. Everybody wants to go to Cooper Flagg, but don't forget about Knipple, who scored 15 first-half points on five threes.
An outlet pass for Caleb Foster, streaming across midcourt left to right. Whips it to the corner for Knipple. His three is good. Con Knipple is feeling it. He's 5 of 7 from outside, and Lincoln wants a timeout.
45-28 the score there. Five threes, 15 points for Knipple. And the Blue Devils, as a team, really lit it up from beyond the arc in that first half. Tyrese Proctor helping a 9-for-19 call to punctuate the first 20.
Now they're just going to run some offense. Here's James. Back up top, Tyrese has it. Lincoln's gone zone. James on the right. Back up top, Tyrese. He'll take a deep three and hit it. Tyrese Proctor has 15 and the lead back to 22.
After one half of play, it was 56-34. We go to the second half, and Cooper Flagg, after scoring 13 in the first half, he would go on to score 9 in the second half, and he wasted no time getting into a rhythm in the second stanza as the guy that they call Coop, 6'9", 205-pound freshman out of Newport, Maine, number one recruit in the country, delivered early in the second half.
Up top, Sion James. To the right it goes, and Konkanipal. He'll drive into the paint, pull up, kick up top for James. Around the perimeter goes for Cooper Flagg. Steps through a double team, punches it down, and he's fouled. My goodness.
Cooper Flagg showing the full arsenal here against Lincoln University. He's been inside, he's been outside, he's been passing the ball, he's been blocking shots. Cooper Flagg, a little bit of everything here in his opener.
Konkanipal said, though, he wanted some of that as well on the next possession.
Flagg on the drive, left side of the paint, got inside, whipped it to the right corner. Konkanipal can't hit the three. Offensive rebound, Malawach. He's got cutters on the right. How about Kahn for the right-hand punch? My goodness, what a finish.
Delighting the Cameron Crazies in their freshman debut. The Blue Devils up 65-38.
Konkanipal, 6'7", 217-pound freshman out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, number one player, coming out of the Cheese State. And then there's another freshman, a center at 7'2", 250. This one from South Sudan, Kamon Mahuak. He wanted in on the dunk party also.
Proctor to cue it in. Waits, gets it for Malawach, right back for Tyrese on the left corner. Drives, lobs, Malawach to throw it down. And that wasn't easy. It was a little bit low. I had to catch it kind of under the rim, take it above the rim, and plenty of strength to punch it down.
67-43 was the second half score there. The lead would grow to as large as 52 in the final moments before Duke polished off the Lions 107-56. But there was one more worthy highlight from Cooper Flagg to bring to the table that made it a 31-point game. Cooper finishing the break.
Torber has it knocked loose by Cooper Flagg at midcourt, trying to get it back, could not. It's into the hands of Caleb Foster. There's Brown, the lob, and Flagg will throw it down.
Great lob from Brown, and Cooper Flagg just took it with one hand and ripped that rim down.
Malik Brown, the Syracuse transfer, queuing up the freshman in Flagg. Again, Flagg 22 points to lead the Blue Devils in scoring. 107-56 was the exhibition final. We will rejoin you for another Blue Devil men's basketball broadcast coming up a week from tomorrow, 6 o'clock airtime ahead of a 7 o'clock start. The second and final exhibition game against Bobby Hurley in the Arizona State Sun Devils charity event to benefit Duke Children's Hospital. 7 o'clock tip, 6 o'clock our network coverage will begin with the Reed's Jewelers countdown to tip-off. That's a week from tomorrow, next Sunday night, October 27th, beginning at 6 o'clock. For John Roth and John Rose and the voice of the Blue Devils, David Schumann, I've been your host, Kyle Schatzberger. Final score again from Cameron one more time. Duke 107, Lincoln University 56. It's been Duke Basketball from Learfield.
Thank you for listening to Duke Basketball on the Blue Devils Sports Network from Learfield. Our coverage has been brought to you by Coca-Cola. Crisp, refreshing, and irresistibly tasty. Is Coke Zero Sugar the best Coke ever? Try and decide. Reed's Jewelers, your home for fine Swiss timepieces, beautiful diamonds, and the world's most luxurious jewelry brands. Reed's Jewelers, trusted with life's moments. By Continental Tire, the exclusive tire of the Blue Devils. Find the right tire for your vehicle at ContinentalTire.com. Continental Tire, the smart choice in tires. By the Hilton Garden Inn, your home base near Duke University. By Duke Health, be a game changer. The Duke team is pioneering the future of healthcare for communities in the Triangle and beyond. Discover what's possible at careers.dukehealth.org. And by the Washington Duke Inn, honoring tradition over trend for over 30 years. The preceding has been a Learfield presentation of the Blue Devils Sports Network.